Welcome to another episode of The Flank. All right, I'm joined by my friend, my companion, my duo, the one, the only, No! It's not Benjamin Seam. It's the one, the only, Donovan Templorado. Let's give it up for Temp, guys.
Clap for myself.
Fuck Ben. Listen, guys.
Should I say that too?
Yeah, say fuck Ben.
Fuck Ben.
Fuck Ben. You motherfucker. Listen. Benjamin Seam, you know, something came up today. He bailed on me on the last second. You know, you really think that you know people, but sometimes, you know, their true colors come out, guys, and Ben bailed on me today. But I got my fucking duo in here. Fucking Donnie Temp. Me and Temp go back. We were roommates last year. You know what I'm saying? This guy's the marksman. This guy don't fucking miss. You understand? So I want to give a huge shout out to Donnie, man. Donnie, thank you for coming on, bro.
No problem, man. You know I'll be here. I'm always here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. You came on. I mean, we're just going to talk some COD. I mean, the matches today, the first one was really good. The second one was kind of fugazed. And then we're going to answer some questions on Reddit. And real quick, I want to give a huge shout out to Feast and Mischief. You guys are going rogue right now in Dexel. We got people coming in the chat showing a lot of love today, which is nuts. Feast, thank you for the 50 fucking bombs, the gifted subs. My own, this guy's nuts. So let's get a Weez in the chat, man. Show this guy some love. We'll give him a quick shout out real quick since he came in and dropped a bomb as the show started. So shout out to Feast, shout out to Mischief and Dexel, but let's get this show on the road. We also got some other people joining us today. We have Z, we have Adam, we have Soap, and then I think Doug Sensor Martin will be joining us some way, I think somewhere throughout the show.
Shit.
Donnie and Doug, there might be a little beef. There might be some beef there, but hopefully the beef doesn't come out today on the flank. And then,
I feel like it's better if it does come out, though.
You think it's better if it comes out? That's good.
It's bad for me if it comes out, but I feel like it's better for the show if it comes out. So
yeah,
we'll see if I sell out or not.
Fuck it, man. Fuck it, bro. I mean, it is what it is. You know, we got to let it all out sometimes, Don. And then fucking Nameless might be joining us as well. He said he'll join in towards the end of the show. But it's nice of you to join us, guys. We got Soap, Z, Adam. You guys want to say anything? Want to say hello?
Hey, how you doing, guys?
What's going on, Soap?
Hey, guys. How's it going?
What's up, Adam? Z, are you there, kid? Don't tell me Z's not there. Unbelievable.
I'm sorry, I was eating. How's it going, guys?
Oh, shit, it's okay. You can mute your mic and go back to eating. What you eating over there, Z?
Panda Express.
Oh, that shit must be banging. Interesting. Soap, you got a shirt on?
Yeah, I got a shirt on.
Okay, interesting. That's new. Let's get it going, guys. We're going to get right.
You want it off?
No, please, keep it on.
Nah, keep it on, bro. Keep it on.
So
take it off, man.
Definitely keep it on.
Adam, what the fuck?
Have you seen this guy, man?
Yeah,
he looks good.
His chest is hairy as fuck. It's one of the hairiest I've ever seen. I'm not even joking. But
no, I shaved it.
You shaved it?
Yeah.
Why?
It had to be done.
Okay, whatever. So, what are you going to
do? What
do
you mean?
What do you mean? Let's get it going. Soap, you also got to hit a putt for me at the end of the show. I think you need to hit a putt for
us. I don't know how you want me to do that.
You don't got a putting mat?
I got a small room.
Yeah, true. Ben Janicine does come in clutch with that.
Ben is rich. He's got a huge penthouse.
Yeah, but
Ben is rich, man.
But he can't hit a fucking putt to save his life.
I know. I don't know what that's about.
When he can't buy talent.
Remember when we were live at the flank and he was complaining about the right to left of the stage, Tommy?
Yeah, bro. We were on stage at the IRL flank, guys, and he brought a putting mat to hit it for the IRL show.
He was shaking,
and he went to go get some test shots up there, Don, right? And he goes, dude, I can't hit a putt. The stage is crooked. It's going right to left. I said, it's going right to left, Ben? He said, yeah, it's going right to left. I said, I don't know, Ben. I don't know what the fuck you want, bro. You just can't hit putts. You can't hit putts. But what are you going to do, man? Ben Janicim, he won't be joining us today. He's sitting in traffic, apparently. So we're going to let him do his thing, but we're going to get right into it, man. We're going to kick things off here. We start things off with Toronto going up against the Florida Mutineers. Now, guys, it might be a little ghetto today, okay? You're going to see me controlling this stuff because usually Ben is obviously controlling this stuff. But I'm going to have to do everything today. I'm controlling everything. I'm controlling all the scenes. So I'll do the best I can. But we're going to have some fun and we're going to do the show regardless. The show must go on, I always say. So the first match was interesting. Don, this was a good fucking series, man. This was back and forth, especially this first map.
Yeah, wait, hold on 1 second. Is it supposed to be playing for me? Because it's not.
Mm-mm. No, you got to watch my stream.
Oh, okay, all right.
Just watch my stream, because I'm not going to do the watch
nah,
party.
No, you're good. All right.
It'll be like 2-3 seconds
first
delay,
map,
but...
Nah, yeah, first map was super close. They actually won with, like, the time running out. That was kind of weird. When we've been scrimming Toronto recently, like, a lot of the hard points have been, like that. Like, Cammy posted a screenshot the other day, and it was versus us. He was, like, 43 and 42, like... games just ending off of like everyone's got 7K, time's running out. So I don't know what's up with that, but they got the job done.
Like, you think it's just like people are just like so close and skilled now? Like everybody knows how to play the game. It's a lot of contest heavy hills and stuff. Like it's just going down to the wire a lot.
That could be a part of it. I feel like a lot of people, like most teams, definitely know what to do. They may not execute it properly, but they definitely have an idea of what to do now.
Uh-huh.
So that could definitely be it. But I don't know. I feel like they're definitely they're going a little rogue as well.
Yeah, no, they're definitely going a little rogue.
This happened in a lot of their games.
And I feel like Florida is like, aren't they known for that? Like
they're going super rogue too. Yeah. So I feel like they're just both going rogue, and Toronto ended up closing it out.
Yeah, they ended up closing it out, but it was a good series. I think it wasn't until, like, the fourth map that Toronto really just put Florida to bed. But the first three maps are insane. Bantz was going the fuck off today, man. I don't know what this guy's been eating for breakfast, but this fucking guy's been nuts. And it's honestly, is he, like, one of the most improved players this year, do you think?
Yeah.
I think he is, man. And I don't know if it's not just a talent thing. It's just the way he thinks about the game. I feel like he's a really smart player, no?
Yo.
Yeah, I personally feel like 5v5 hurt him a lot.
Oh, what's going on, Nameless? Hey, we got Nameless in the call. Welcome to the flank, Anthony Nameless.
What's
up, How you doing?
What's going on, my brothers?
Long time, man.
Yeah,
man. It's good to have you in here, bro. We're just chilling, talking about COD, man. Sorry to cut you off, Don. I didn't know.
Are you good?
Somebody just came in. But Nameless, welcome, man. I'll get back to your point, Don. What were you saying?
You're saying Ben's most improved. I agree. Uh-huh. I feel like 5v5 hurt him a lot because 5v5 was more of like you had to be smart with your team, but at the end of the day, you got to just go just trade everything out. You know what I'm saying? Like 4v4, he could just pre-aim with a sub, get his kills, make smart plays, and just be a hard kill on the map. And I feel like just going forward in 4v4, he's just going to continue to play well.
No, 100%. It's a different game, right? Dude, it's so much of a difference when you add that player to the map. Like when it's 5v5 to 4v4, it's like more methodical. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot more methodical. But we should go on board with the listening with Toronto Ultra. These guys have had some weird comms throughout the year. So I want to tune in and see how they sound, and then we'll give our thoughts.
Yo, drop me the link to this thing.
It's just on my stream, because if I do the watch together, I got to, like, minimize the screen to, like, move it around, and it'd just be a hassle. So you just got to watch it on my stream. Yeah, it's a little fucked up today, Ant, because Ben is not here. So I got to control everything myself. Cool. But it's okay. It shouldn't be a problem. But let's tune into the listening. Shout out to Astral Gaming. Let's go into an Astral Game listening with Toronto Ultra.
Let's go. He's pushed out. I'm dead, man. He's
already
P1. Already P1.
Oh, okay, wait.
One's on time.
I'm green, dead.
Nice. Let's go.
Oh, go.
Deep back. Deep back.
I'm back. Catch him.
Main green, first.
Let's like thing.
Yeah, he's kill me. Deep square, guys. Square.
He's on the ramp as well. Wait,
man.
I tell you,
stay alive.
Wait.
Nah, I spawned right. Yeah. You can wrap left here.
Stay alive.
Yeah, spawn close left. He's probably out. I'm watching inner. Yeah.
I'm behind him.
Top gray. I'm watching inner. Inner Neptune with the weak.
One's top green.
Outer.
Hit your ramp. Okay, well,
top green.
Neptune was in the top.
They spawn back.
Have a good top green, you said.
Top green,
right?
Deep.
Yeah, he was.
Okay, I'm
deep left, deep left.
Wait, where are you guys?
I don't see Havoc right now. I'm deep.
Make sure you block.
Deep left, Jimmy. Screaming.
Okay. Going for Havoc.
That's weak.
Deep left.
I don't know where he's going. Where is he? Okay,
two deep. Both of y'all deep.
Havoc on the tank, and then I got shot in the back. One's deep. Nice. On time.
I'm making a one shot. One more behind you.
I spawned fucking in the back still. The spawn and break. Spawn and break.
One's a break.
Yeah. Right, I'm already out.
Hello, Ben.
It might spawn floating on you.
Rails,
wait, connector.
I'm on rails.
Rails.
I have a one shot plat. Spawn here. They could have made bricks.
Yep.
Yeah, in connector. Shower me.
That'd be weak.
Okay, one shot.
Ran. Top green.
Guys, in half.
One shot.
Top green.
Let
me out, right?
Hit down gold.
Yeah, in gold. Guys, one shot. Ran back to tight.
We're looking for one left.
Yeah, on left somewhere. I don't know where.
Play for him?
I think he's probably P2, yeah. He's probably P2 on the side or something. Unless he's out. Right side mid.
He's towards
he's
not P4.
I'm waiting for P4. Right, top green awakening got me.
I'm right up here. Nice, Jimmy.
Nice, Ben. Good job. I spawned out.
Yeah, top green.
I spawned
plat. Nice. I spawned plat.
Neptune.
Enemy?
Yeah.
Weak. Nice. Where are they spawning? Spawning floating.
Yeah, could be floating in back left.
Yeah, okay. I'm on the creek. Yeah, floating skies. Kind of weak. Floating skies.
Give me Havoc.
Okay, the one's rails as well.
Where's he going?
Hey, I mean, listening was good, man. I mean, they sound good to me. A lot of energy, a lot of small talk, calling out what they have, challenging together. I think that's, like, the most important thing is just trying listening to their cons and making sure that they're using teamwork, you know, and not just calling out basic shit. But what do you guys think? What do you think, Don?
Great comps. Fantastic comps.
Fantastic. It's fucking
I think they have – I like their listenings and Optic's listenings. I think Optic has – probably a little bit better comms than them, but they're right there with them. I just like how they stay calm and you can hear everything. Like, you can listen.
Oh, yeah. Like, dude, optics comms are insane, though.
Insane.
Right? Their comms sound like it's like a work of art.
They hear everything. They hear everything. Mm-hmm. They can ask questions like, yo, you want to hit this? Yeah, I'm down. Like, there's certain teams where you just don't have a chance to even do that because everyone's just yelling like, he's one shot, child. Like, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah,
I feel 100%. Like their comms are really good.
What do you think, Ant?
I think it's wonderful. When you can actually have like a conversation mid-game, like it's all like a plan, right? Mm-hmm. And when you're having a conversation mid-game like that and everybody can understand, listen, while also doing their job, like that's money. And you can even see there was a point in that listening where what we're talking about was illustrated perfectly. And his Vance got a little bit hyped. He started screaming. He's like, yo, they're both gens. He got hyped. And then everybody was like, all right, chill. Yeah. And then they got right back into it, right? So it's like, and clearly he doesn't get frustrated from that either, like when they say that. So it's just good team chem right there.
Yeah, it's good team chem. They all listen to each other. That's like the main thing. Like they have respect for each other and trust in each other that if somebody says something, they all listen. So I think that's one thing that always separated Toronto from the rest, or at least the teams at the top, like FaZe Toronto, Dallas, like teams like that. One thing you can't deny is their teamwork. And the same with Optic now, who obviously took down FaZe. So, you know, the teams at the top, that's one of the things you definitely focus on. I mean, we saw it in the process video. I don't know if you guys checked out the process from Optic, but that was something they worked on, like their communication.
Yeah.
They went back and made sure that their comms were on point and that they changed up their comms a little bit because they felt like they were too hectic. If your comms are too hectic, your play style is going to be too hectic. It's kind of like you play off the feel of the game. So it's definitely something a lot of these teams work on. But Toronto, they end up holding on strong in this one. It was just a very back and forth game. Honestly, Florida, they were holding those P1, P2s well. I think Toronto rotated and got most of the time on these P3s.
For the last one.
Yeah, it went all the way down to the wire, and this game. It went all the way down to the wire. And, you know, this Florida team's been impressing me. I feel like they've really kicked up these last few weeks, no?
Yeah, I mean, I've been saying it quite a bit when it comes to Florida. Like, I don't know if you remember, I was a huge Florida fan, like, mid-season when they were starting to play well. I just feel like they play like bully COD still. Like, they have to be slaying like crazy, like, for them to be consistent. It's just sometimes somebody takes a crazy route or doesn't hold what they need to hold, and it just becomes fucking chaotic. Mm-hmm. And that's why Mutineers' hardpoints are so insane, because it's like that so often.
I mean, that's what Donnie said, too. I mean, Donnie was saying how they just go rogue. You know,
yeah, they go rogue. Yeah, like
they just Havoc go rogue.
Or Awakening. Awakening especially.
Nah, Awakening
he goes rogue
supreme,
a lot.
Bro.
Yeah, dude. And it costs them. And that's why they have these close-ass hard points. And it's stressful. They got to slay like crazy.
Mm-hmm. Which is why I wonder why, like, they don't figure this out. Because I feel like this is kind of like the story of Florida throughout the year. And you would think that, you know, I think for me, at least, Neptune's been kicking it up. Like, a lot of these guys have just been really kicking it up on Florida. Especially Neptune. That's why I said his name. But, you know, they have to go back and realize that, you know, they're making plays like that where they're just going so fucking rogue. And if they can clean it up and maybe stay a little bit more disciplined and clean up their play styles a little bit, I mean, this is a team that'll be really good. They're going to be tough to beat. I mean, their talent from top to bottom is insane.
You know what it is, though? It's those plays that they make when they're going rogue, it works for them sometimes, right? So in a lot of the players in individual mind, it's like, this is how we got control of this hill. So it like it's just like second nature to chow that gunfight or to make that play. So it's just like to the core of their gameplay. And it's so late now. We were talking about in the green room. I was like, I don't even know if they could fix it. They just need to all be on fire for them to make a run.
Yep. I mean, one thing you can't take away from them is their confidence. I mean, these guys are definitely not scared to challenge and really get into the mix. You know what I'm saying?
They're not scared.
Definitely not scared. Yeah, maybe a little overly confident at times. But they definitely got talent to you know, take a lot of these top teams and, you know, really push their limits. So I think Toronto was tested a little bit today. They ended up clutching up to the end. I think towards the end of this game, it went all the way down to the time limit, which is what Donnie was saying a little bit. It's interesting to see some of these maps going down to the time limit, but I guess that's mostly just like a playstyle thing. But this got really mixy. Toronto ended up getting out of the hill. You'll see this at the end of games. Like, do teams want to stay in the hill and try and finish the game? Or with only 15 seconds left in the clock, I think Toronto made the right play to ultimately just get out of this hill and just let this time dwindle down. And it was pretty much an easy win for them. They locked down the rotation, and they played smart. They just locked down a rotation, made sure that they got this P2, and they can just win it here. It's a very hard hill to break, so I think Toronto made the right decision, and it's those smart plays that ultimately got them the win here at the end of this map number one. So good plays out of them.
Great plays.
And then we go into the S&D. The S&D was another good one. Florida's S&D has been really good, bro. No?
Really good.
I swear they've been smoking people in S&D.
They have good S&D players.
Yeah,
just all around the board. Like, Neff's been grinding Chow's. Like, every time I play Chow's with him or against him, he's always frying.
Really? Is that like a thing? Like, players? Yeah,
I didn't know that was like a thing.
Yeah, I've been playing I've been playing S&D Chow's. Neff's been playing S&D Chow's. A few other pros been playing S&D Chow's.
I saw you and TJ streaming them. Yeah, I didn't know that a bunch of people were playing them, though. That's
nah, Neff's been grinding Chow's. That kid's, he's nasty right now.
He's different, man. He's moving Caesar, different.
Caesar's been playing Chow's, too. Caesar's been playing really good, too, in S&D.
His start on this map was masterclass.
Yeah, Skies, for those of you who don't know, Caesar's
Skies. Oh, yeah, Skies, my bad. Skies been frying in S&D, too, so.
Yeah, he's been doing his
thing.
That's
where he comes from.
Oh, yeah, Standy, too. Standy's been playing a lot of Chow's. Like, people have been grinding.
Yeah, that's interesting, because I'm going to start tuning in to some of those Chow's. I didn't realize that was happening.
Yeah, get me in there.
Consistently. Oh, shit.
I can still throw down. I think this is.
No, 100%. 100%. Bro, it's like riding a bike. You know, you can always shoot straight.
Especially S&D. I'm hopping in, bro. 2,000 IQ.
I just heard some more delusional about my life, man. Stay off the six, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got Study joining us on the flank today. What's going on, Jay?
What's good, Jay?
What's up, fellas?
We got a crew here today. I kind of fuck with this.
Great job on the cast today, Jay. Killed it, brother.
Baby. Yeah, Jay, you've been doing your thing. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you, baby.
He was going in on Surge, which we'll get to later.
Yeah, we'll get to them. I mean, I don't know if we're going to talk much about it, but we can we could put some thoughts into that series. I wasn't gonna go too in depth into it, but saw the Subtane came out today from Octane, and Maron, we gotta talk about that shit. But listen, fuck it, Florida, they came out. I think for Florida, they make a lot of unorthodox plays in S&D. They're not scared to hit routes. Like you see people doing like weird shit, and that's what I like to see. Honestly, I like seeing players that aren't scared to make individual plays. Because I think that's just unpredictable. Like, I feel like some teams are just so predictable. They do such basic shit, such basic setups. But Florida do a good job, like, mixing it up and trying to change up the pace of the game. And plus, like, what Donnie said, I mean, their S&D players their team is just full of S&D players.
This map was actually really good, though. Like, Florida went ahead, and then Toronto started clutching up, and, like, they brought it back to, like, 4-4. Mm-hmm. And I think that's later down in the game. I know I'm going ahead, but Nep made a really good play going into Delhi and just sneaking through and just holding the whole thing down. Like
he's
at that point,
being annoying
like,
as hell.
He's being annoying as hell.
Him?
Yeah,
that's what he does best. That's what he does best. Honestly,
they went down 0-3.
Yeah, I mean Florida, they really kicked up off the beginning. Skies was close to streaks. He ended up crossing
it out. Oh, we should talk about
bit.
That. I feel like they played that round a little
weird,
shook.
Right?
They played it shook, bro. They played it way too hard for the streaks.
What
it was like
it?
The 3-0 when they went up 3-0.
When they were up 3-0, yeah. Skies was running for dear life.
Yeah.
They played that a little too scared. Like I feel like they should have like probably played it more straight up and just Caesar just hard baits his teammates. But like I don't know what the hell like their strat was basically.
Mm-hmm. It seemed like
it is literally let them run across and plant the bomb. Like they played it like a little too scared in my opinion.
Let's take a look at the round a little bit more. Let's see how they ended up breaking off. So to start the round. It looked like they pushed through
went
A.
B
pretty sure
mid.
Toronto lost full and just said, fuck it, and they just ran straight through. Like,
so you can see
now,
I'm right?
Tripping.
I'm going to pause it here. I mean, their initial setup as the round starts 15 seconds in, they have two guys stacked in A.
Oh,
mid-map
oh yeah, they
is
fucked
wide
up
open.
The trophy. No, they should have put their trophy in a different spot. That's what happened. They blew up the trophy, and they just backed them out with a nade.
Mm-hmm. Backed them out with a nade. I'm going to play it out. So Skies, you could tell he's kind of hanging back a little bit. Like, he's trying to bait his teammates maybe, maybe try and work a pick. Bro, I always get nervous when the middle of the map is open like this. I just feel like
on this map,
make,
yeah.
Play. Yeah, like people could just make plays.
Only your envoy's hitting that, brother.
Yeah, and so, listen.
No one knows. You don't got to worry about that,
I
brother.
Mean, listen, bro. Listen, man.
Versus
I,
you, I'm watching that for sure.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm watching
that. 100%. Are you gunning me, though?
Maybe not, but I'm watching it.
Okay,
I'm gonna hit you.
That.
I'm gonna get you weak for
that.
Sure.
I definitely respect that a lot.
See, I like this adjustment out of Florida right here, though. But it's just what happens after. It just gets kind of crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I think what, bro. I'm gonna pause it here. This situation sucks ass, bro. When you're on defense and they get that A bomb down and they plant it for their spawn and there's just people in their spawn just holding.
Running into a sandwich. They're running into a
sandwich. Awakening does a good job opening it up. But Kleenex picks up a two-piece here, if I remember correctly. He gets one.
Oh, he chowed, bro.
Yeah,
this
he
is
went
a nice
rogue.
Chow.
He went rogue.
He said, fuck it.
Yeah, he's
well, like,
nuts.
When they made that adjustment, they just had to get a pick, like, right away when they went towards elbow, and they didn't. So they basically just got screwed.
And then right here, Skies looked like a headless chicken. He's one off streaks.
Yeah.
And he's running around. I thought he should have just stayed
like,
in the building.
Sit a corner.
Yeah,
like.
Yeah, sit a corner and turn your headset up, and we could get to that. You saw Insight's 1v1 clutch when he sat in a corner for 45 seconds.
That was great.
You know, it's like 200 IQ, I guess. Definitely got to turn up the heads a little bit. Skies went a little rogue. I think he went a little rogue. Probably could have got those streaks. But this is when fucking Ultra started making the comeback. I think Florida go up, what, 4-1, and then Ultra bring it all the way back?
Yeah, they tied up 4-4.
It's 4-4.
Mm-hmm.
Then it comes down to that Neptune play. Like,
Yeah, 4-4. I think it was 4-4.
4-4 when he was trapped in Delhi.
Okay,
yeah,
so let's check
that
it
was
out.
A great play.
Let's check it out. Let's go to 4-4. Jay, you're looking real good on that desk.
Thank you, baby. You know, I gotta make sure I'm looking good. Haircut's always fleeky.
Back it up a little bit. Just a little bit.
One thing you'll never have to worry about is looking good. I'll tell you.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you. Neither do you.
But let's check it out. Thank you, Jay. I appreciate that, big guy. But let's go back into it, right? 4-4. This is kind of the swing round, right? It's this offense round. I think this, you know, winning offenses is so big, man, especially on standoff. But Neptune, he ends up making a play through yellow. You see him in Awakening, like, kind of shimmying mid-map, like, trying to play some information here. This was risky as hell, too. Like, Neptune's like, fuck it, you know, I'm out.
He went rogue,
and I like it, because he's on offense, right? So he's like, fuck it, I gotta make a play. He ends up going rogue, he gets into yellow. And, bro, once that player's in yellow...
It's over.
It's hard, man. And if you're Toronto, I think the only thing you could do here is maybe try and double-team him, like, rotate back, try and get this kid out of yellow, because Insight sees him right here.
I don't think you can.
When a player
that,
like
though.
Neptune's in yellow, you're not getting the
you're
monitor, bro.
You're
he's sliding back and forth.
In that spot, he's guaranteed one. Like you, I don't think you can let him get there.
Like a Shotzi or Neptune.
Even the shimmy grenade that he threw
was elite.
This shimmy grenade right here was like Jesus. This guy's twisted. Like
yeah.
Jeez, man, who the fuck is this guy? He's fucking curving. He's throwing curveballs at the door. I'm like, what the hell?
There. Yeah, this is a fucked situation.
Yeah, so he ends up staying. He's dipping and weaving. Cammy's losing fucking composure back here. Cammy gets one here, though. He does pick up Havoc. And that's, bro, I thought once he got Havoc, he was going to work Neptune.
What is Havoc doing, though?
I don't know. Havoc went rogue. And
just sit on the fucking refrigerator and pray in the corner, brother.
Yeah, Havoc went fucking rogue, bro.
His job is to just make sure nobody gets through and
he
gets
was
to the wall.
He was just trying to like help Neptune.
Nah,
as
no,
much
he's trying
he
to get
could,
the phone. Make sure you get
Neptune.
Pushed.
He didn't really need help in the situation that he was in.
But even right here, once Cammy gets that pick, I'm thinking they know Neptune's in there. Maybe wait for his teammate, slide in there together. I don't know. I feel like you got to do something together here when Neptune's in here. But
yeah.
He ends up getting a two piece. Like Cammy kind of went, but maybe he panicked a little bit with the time limit going down. But bro, if they trade out Nep and yellow, they can win that round for sure. They get him out of yellow. They maybe somebody hops him on, somebody look over him. Like, just, you know, you put the pressure on Florida. But Neptune does a great job. I mean, this guy's all over the fucking place. So he ends up popping a big two-piece, so good plays out of him.
He's twisted.
Then they switch sides. Toronto goes on to an offense, and then they end up sending this to around 11. And again, Havoc, he goes rogue. He gets taken down. He went rogue 2 runs in a row. He went rogue.
It was a double push. It was
and listen, that's twice now. I saw in the Seattle series with Nicola, Nicky D. He did the same thing. They run into Brown, and they don't even check the stairs. They just
check it.
Why?
I don't know.
They don't check the stairs. I see players doing it all the time. I'm like, dude, I play league play. I check the stairs. You know, I'm like, I'm surprised some of these pros, maybe they think they hit a timing or something. Like, I don't know kind of like why they do it. But I've seen it a couple times already, so it's just like I'm a little confused. But they go rogue. Florida tries to make plays around the back. I personally think if Florida's on the defense and you want round to win, like, just hold.
Just
like,
make them work for it.
Yeah, make Toronto work for it. You know, you're putting the pressure on them now. Like, it's game point. And they push them, you know, and they fall right into Toronto's trap. They send this to around number 11, and this is where Florida clutch up. Cammy on your screen, now you have Toronto, who end up having the offensive round. So you got to look at the Florida Mutineers. They were turning up throughout the game, so they got blessed with the defense. And they hold. They do what I thought fucking they should have done. They played it safe. They have everything covered. And they have a guy shimmying back alley, guy mid map, two guys stacked onto the point. And then I think at this point, if you're Toronto, you're like, shit, you know, what the hell do you do? They try to work some picks here. I did get a little mixy. It always gets mixy on this site, huh? Standoff, this A bomb site. I feel like there's always trades going down. People.
This is literally
rogue.
Just the rogue area, bro. Like, you saw versus who did we just lose to? New York. Mac went rogue in the little cube. Like, whoever
went
rogue.
Oh, when you got that three-piece, bro.
In a box, bro.
Yeah, whoever goes more rogue in the box is probably going to win the map, bro. That's what it comes down to, bro.
My guy's in a fucking box going nuts.
We're getting thunderclapped in the box, bro.
Mac went rogue. And listen, these guys right here, I mean, you could tell, right?
They're going rogue, too.
15 seconds left in Toronto. They waited too long, man. They just, like, it all fell apart. They lost the trades. And at that point, you know, they got Bubapta, and it's all over.
I also feel like in that situation, that 5-5, like, if Vance has that
SMG in his hands, like, he's probably going to go for that trade. Yeah. Since he found himself with the Krig, like, that up and close on a gunfight is not going to be easy, so he doesn't even try to take it. Yep. And I feel like they just wasted a lot of time in that final round, and they just let Florida just win it on defense by just playing defense, not doing anything extra.
I hate pushing that bomb site when you, especially round 11, wasting a lot of time in the round. Like, I'd much rather try to take mid map and get like a pick from B and a bomb plant. Mm-hmm. I just feel like it's easier to like try to work inside a yellow.
100%. Definitely it's, sucks. I agree too. You need a sub pushing that site on offense because you need somebody getting mixy in there. Like, with a Krig, it's hard to do that. So I agree with you, Jay, for sure. But they end up losing it, and then we go into a garrison control. And going back to the last map, you had Awakening and Skies really pop off. So I want to give them a shout out. They've been playing well. So then we go into the garrison control, and we know how this is, bro. It's so defensive heavy. I think Toronto had them in the fucking blender.
On the last round, they blended the shit out of them,
dude,
bro.
Dude, it was actually fun to watch. No bullshit.
When
that
they
was
got into the setup there,
that shit was smooth.
When they got into that setup, we were all chatting shit. I'm like, oh, it's over. As soon as they get this wipe, and they got four in a row, I'm like, it's over. Toronto's good in those positions.
I mean, even the first defense, I'm pretty sure Toronto get them off here, right? And they get them off the point. They win the defense with these. We know how defensive heavy these garrison controls are, man. I mean, we can watch it back. I definitely want to watch back the last round when Toronto put them in the blender. But they, you know, we know how it is. I don't think that anybody went in offense. Nobody did, right?
No, it was straight defense. But straight the way that Toronto dominated on their defenses was insane, because that very first round was the only second that we see Florida getting on one of these points. Like, they don't get on a point for the rest of the offensive rounds that they have.
Yep.
Toronto's been good.
No, you can go ahead. Go ahead.
I'm going to say Toronto's been like really good at control, but we haven't seen them dominate on their defenses like this in a minute. Like, it was fucking clinical.
Yeah.
It was a back and forth game. It went to the end, but it just felt like Toronto was the better squad this whole
I think map. It's this map, bro. I'm gonna be honest.
It's scary, bro. Yeah.
I think
scary.
The only people that should play Toronto on this map is probably like FaZe and maybe Dallas. Maybe.
Yeah.
This is a definite veto. This is just a sound horde. Like, this is probably Bance's best control map.
Mm-hmm. It's just so many areas, bro.
So many areas
people
of
in
finesse,
the back,
like,
son. Like,
he's everywhere.
Gotta be annoying,
son,
to play against this guy.
Just get this map out of here, bro. Make him play raid or check like something else, bro.
Listen, but Toronto, we got to think too. Even if you don't win the offensive round, hey, getting a point and getting a tick or two, you're basically winning the fucking round.
Yeah.
You know, once it goes into overtime, I mean, it comes down to the objective and kind of who got the most ticks. So Toronto, they come out with a W on their offense. They shut down Florida. They're not able to do anything on their offense, and then Toronto's able to cap a point and get a tick over by that A site. So definitely helps them when it goes into that overtime. It allows them to just get that defense when it fucking matters. So Toronto. They put him in the blender, man. Absolute blender. Was it this round? They put him in the blender twice, did they not?
Yeah.
The first round, and then last round was an absolute blender, bro. Like there was zero shadow of a doubt.
I mean, bro, to be fair, it's so hard to get
out of these traps. Yeah, it's super hard.
Like, you see the way Toronto bait and switches each other, too. They're always with each other. Like, they're always trying to work off one another. And you got to give them credit. I mean, when you have somebody... You guys have played COD professionally. When you pick up another gun, when you have an AR and a sub in your hand, do you not feel like you're in rhythm?
You're double positive. You pull up the back button, you're on fucking front. Yep. Start slaying, bro. That's literally what crosses your mind, isn't it? You can't be stopped.
I swear to God, whenever somebody picks up another gun and they got an AR and a sub, they're just untouchable. They're just in that rhythm. Like, they're in that rhythm and they can't get taken out.
Yeah.
But you see it, right? Toronto, they have every lane covered. They're holding crossfires. They're constantly trading each other. They're constantly filling in gaps off spawn. It's just so hard. I mean, Florida's going through it. Let's be honest. They're probably losing fucking composure. I think this ends up going to a round number 5.
He didn't die that whole round. Bance didn't die the whole round.
This guy's 20 and 10.
Yo, veto the map, dog.
He's 20 and fucking 10. And even Toronto, they tried to close it out. This one got pretty close, man. It got a little mixed.
Yeah.
Listen, Toronto was making plays. They had the right idea on garrison control. Work the back, work through bricks, try and get kills, and then try and pinch onto the point and stack the point. I mean, everybody pretty much tries to do the same thing. But Florida do a good job holding on strong, but it's when it gets into that overtime, things get a little bit mixy, and this was the worst blender in its overtime. Toronto was pushed up in their spawn. I think it was Cammy who I was like, holy shit, this guy cannot die.
Yeah, it's that wipe they get, dude. They're set up and they get a clean squad wipe, and it's just like, it's over.
Can I ask you something?
Right here.
Number 6, Caesar Skies. He finds a gap. He gets out. He finds a gap in their setup. Why does he run backwards?
Because he thinks there's going to be another one.
Did he? He just thought there was another one? Maybe he wanted to, like, do something with his team. Or, like, he didn't want to make an individual play. But at that point, bro, if I've been stuck in a spawn for the last three defenses, I'm like, oh, my God, thank God, I'm in the vent. I'm in the vent, bro.
Yeah, I'm in the vent right now.
But he was sitting there holding because, like, before that, if you back it up a little bit, bench, like, he was holding down that lane. So once he dropped, they got the crossfire already set up. That's the scary shit, is that they already have it set up. Mm-hmm. So, like, if he tries to go out, you already have three teammates who drop. You go out there and you peek, that's four dead.
Okay, I see what happened. His teammate died on the cross. He probably thought he was looking at it. He's probably thinking, you know what, let me wait up and wait for my teammates. But the problem is his teammates can't make it to him. They all keep fucking dying. Like, they're all dying. Like, Kleenex is pushed up in his spot. And this is a god spot, by the way. That's a really good spot, even with a sub. And then Cammy, he gets pushed up in the base. They literally have them pinned in the back right corner
of
the map.
It's over, bro.
Yeah, bro, you're just chalked in the spot. Like, it's just the map. Like Don said, if I was competing still with the demons that are still playing in COD, bro, this shit would be vetoed instantaneously, bro.
Yeah, this shit, 100%. 100%. Jesus. Yeah, I mean, at this point.
What do you do? You're spawning in a corner of the map and everybody's preeming you.
Florida finally got out with 3 seconds left. They get on the point, but, you know, with streaks and everything, I mean, the whole Toronto side probably had streaks. They end up streaking the point. This was all over. Toronto ended up taking a 2-1 lead. And then we go into the raid hard point. And this one wasn't even close, especially off the rip.
That one.
It was 149-6, I think. Yeah, this was the...
I mean, this is where Toronto, they're picking up. What the fuck was that?
The coffin dance. That's what happened. I just didn't understand it because Florida, they were undefeated on this, Don. It was 6-0.
Wait, who was Florida?
They were 6-0 undefeated all year.
And then Florida haven't lost this all year?
All year!
Wait,
really?
That's crazy. I didn't even know that.
I didn't know that.
I had no idea.
They were 6-0.
I wouldn't expect that.
Wait, who was 6-0, Jay?
Florida.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
They got
mollywalked,
dude. They got fucking boom up.
They had 6 points for their 6 wins.
They got fucking shit on. What the fuck? I don't know. Toronto played this shit flawless, bro.
Yep. Dude, Ultras, they've had a couple of these just maps where they skunk a team on Raid.
Wait. How did they just... Wait, can you please back that up? How did they just lose that? There was one guy on rotation.
Well, Toronto, they back off that P1. They go around the back.
Wait, number two's the only guy.
He wins this gunny right here, and then this guy slow chows it, and Cammy kills him, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I mean, Toronto's playing flawless, man. They held all the P1. They spawned out Florida. And then Toronto backed all the way up, and they pushed out the back of the hill together. I mean, they won the fights, and they won the trades, and they did everything together.
Should have stacked the hill or went around.
They should have stacked the hill or went around, 100%. Yeah. Make a play towards basketball, try and shoot somebody in the back. They didn't even play for the back.
That's that rogue shit we were just talking about, you know? It's just like those types of plays.
Just head bashing.
Yeah. Stack the hill, like concede the spawn if they're already back there, and just play from hill or
around. Bance's stats, bro. He is frying.
He was balling, bro. He was a hoop
today.
Mixtape, young Kyrie.
This guy was at another level. But you got to give it to Toronto, man. They play really good COD here. But I agree. It's like, it doesn't need to be everybody from Florida, but one guy needs to take a route, man, and be annoying.
Get a 1.2.
Like, somebody take a route, be annoying, like, you know, do something. Just put the pressure on these guys. But Toronto, again, they hope it too, and then they just work a break. But look how they set up this break, too. Look how they set it up.
The game's over at this point.
Yeah, it's over.
But I'm looking mainly at number three mid map. So you have two guys coming through bedroom. Number three's thinking, you know, what's the best way to break this hill? Pinch it out. Make sure you're blocking all the spawns and spawn them out. And that's what he does. He cuts right across. You see number three at Zig. Instead of just hitting down the stairs, he cuts through. He cuts through Art. He ends up pinching this guy on hill. They get the kills. These guys are spawning all the way out. And then at this point, it's chalked.
It was great timing as well. Yeah. Like they got a kill. So I mean, it was really that two piece on the rotation when those guys spun out and then they collapsed. It was just like, oh, well, we won.
They got the kills. And again, they did it as a unit. I mean, Toronto was storming through as a unit. They're always hugging hands, always.
Yep.
And that's something you don't see, bro. A lot of these bottom teams, it sounds like so easy, but they don't do it.
It's not easy.
Okay, yeah, it sounds easy.
In the moment, it ain't easy, bro. Watching an X-ray view,
it's definitely not easy. In the moment, it's definitely to play tight like that. Like, it just shows like how good their teamwork is and how well they work off each other. You know what I'm saying? At this point, you know, I'm watching the game with Zinni. He's sucking dick. He's like, you know, Toronto's the best. Toronto's the best in the world. This and that. I say, yeah, they're definitely good. Florida started bringing it back a little bit, but I mean, come on, man. At this point, I don't even want to go on board with the comms. They had good comms. They're very energetic. They're trying to bring it back, but Toronto just had too much rhythm and they had.
They're a better team, bro.
Yeah, Toronto's a better team.
Clearly.
And I think once you have so many streaks from Toronto too, it's chalked. He's a fucking chalk, so.
And the crazy part about it, Tom, is like they had a couple sets of streaks, and they only outslayed them by six. They smoked them so bad, and they only beat them in, by six kills.
Isn't
like,
that
how,
crazy?
Huh?
That's fucking nuts.
Wow.
Bro, and it comes down
the right way.
And it comes down to two moments and how great Ultra can capitalize on it. Like the, it's literally that P2 rotation in the very beginning, and Mutineer is just not rotating, setting up on garage properly. It's those two moments. The game was over.
Yep. Good plays at Toronto, man. You saw some frustrations coming from the Florida camp after the match. Toronto getting fucking hype, but here's your final scoreboard again. Just everybody from Toronto just pulling weight.
Somebody
right,
had the math wrong.
You're right, Jay. They didn't outslay quite much.
No, but they rotated early when they could still win at the old. Like the whole Florida roster is at the next hill when Toronto could still win at P3.
I don't know. What the fuck are they doing, Jay? You know these guys. You know what are you gonna do? They end up getting taken out. Shout out to Toronto. I think most of us kind of predicted these Toronto guys to come out and win this one. But it was definitely a great match, man. Florida hung in there. You know, the last map was definitely
maps,
a blowout, but the first few maps were. But look at these guys, man, vibing. Jesus, what? Who the fuck is that? He's fucking dancing and shit. They're going nuts.
Ain't that Insight?
Insight. Yeah,
yo,
what is that?
Yo, he's throwing a shimmy. Hold on. Let's rewind that.
Looking like a young Steph Curry out there.
Look at him go. Look at him go.
Two hops this time.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Them hips ain't lying.
What is that?
Hey, listen, man. It's cool to see these guys vibing, though, and having a good time. You know, I like that shit. You know, they're having fun. They're enjoying themselves, and that's what it's all about.
I like that team.
Yeah, they're a good team, man. They're a really good team. So
they're a really good team.
Shout out to Toronto Ultra. They've been killing it, man, and you know you can really see how good they are as a team when you watch them play. So shout out to those guys. Shout out to Florida. Shout out to both teams for having an entertaining series for us. The next one, not so much. This was dirt shit. We have Seattle Surge going up against Dallas Empire.
They're trolling.
Octane pulled out a sub today.
I couldn't believe it.
What the fuck is that all about, guys?
He actually ran it the whole map, or just
yeah, he ran
the whole
map.
Yeah, he ran it both.
Map one and three.
Both respawns.
Don, listen. I know they're having fun and they're trolling, man, and I'm going to sound like such an old man when I say this, but dude, it just pissed me off seeing that.
Yeah.
It just makes me so mad. And what triggers me is just like, dude, they still have a tournament to play for. They could still make a run. Octane's one of the best ARs ever. You just had a decent land where you guys look better.
He
like,
was
just
trying,
try.
Oh, man.
Just
he
fucking try. Get
and
this practice in.
He's going to run a main AR next year.
Yeah, and you're playing against one of the best teams in the game, and it just flushes me because I like those guys. I like that team, and they're just like on the timeline trolling.
Yep.
That shit pissed me off, bro. Just keep it above.
Yeah, I don't like that shit either. I mean, I it's like you said, it's like you're not just playing, like you're playing for an event that's coming up, right? You still have a chance. It's not like you're just talking. They basically said, we're talking this shit up.
I have a question, though.
What's up?
Nick running the AR?
He got smoked.
Nick was running AR.
Got body bagged even harder with an AR.
Hold on. Before I didn't watch, so I'm not going to roast. So I'm just saying he was getting torched with a sub, though.
I know. Yeah,
so
like,
from Sam's point, I mean, they could argue that, like, bro, like,
no.
We're getting torched that bad with Nick running the sub. Like, why not just switch and just see what happens, you know?
And that's why I was hesitant to, like, speak on it because maybe it was a legit plan. But if it was a legit plan, that's an asinine plan, bro.
But
Sam
they can't make
like,
a roster change, though, and Nick was getting torched with a sub.
I mean, he went
so
20
like,
and 35
why can't,
with the AR.
Why can't they make a roster change? Oh, that's right. Joey Nubsy's on the fucking bench. That's why they can't make a roster change, because these fucking organizations got people like Joey Nubsy on a bench, who has probably a .4 in league play.
I'll say this.
You know what I'm saying?
If they were being legit and trying that out, then whatever. I'll take back my statement. If one of them come on record and saying that they are being legit, either way, in my mind, until somebody says that they were trying to be legit, because they were laughing throughout the series, that they're fucking trolling. That shit's annoying.
They might have been trolling.
Listen, this guy Big P was frying, though. He was trying to do everything.
Yeah, they could have been trolling.
I mean, let's listen to their comms. Let's see how they were sounding. Let's go on board with the Seattle Surge. Shout out to Astro Gaming. Let's see how these guys were comming.
I want to give me two water steps as well.
I'm going to get you.
Reese is already in there.
Yeah, get the time. I have streaks.
Yo, Otter. He's out of far left.
Wander, you can wander it.
Side laundry. Far left shotty weak.
And top laundry.
There's 20 basketball. There's 20 basketball, guys.
Shotty on me, shotty on me. In ring, shotty.
Who? One got me, open steps, open steps right now.
Out of ring.
Steps, Grim got me.
Out of ring, shotty, look at me.
Yo, Laundry's going to push.
Go back,
we don't have to listen to all this. I'm going to minimize it or lower it.
Yeah.
But,
okay.
Listen,
they were trying.
They were trying.
They actually tried it. So what I said was probably right.
I get it. But it just almost sounds like one of those things where it's like, guys, we're just fucking ass. Sam, you want to run a sub this series? Like,
yeah,
that's
no, it
what
is. Yeah, that is exactly how it went.
And to me, that's trolling, though. Like,
but, like, I think personally, like, Nick would play better with an AR. And, like, I looked at the stats, like, yeah, he went neg 20, but he did. I mean, he got a lot of damage. Like, he was shooting, like. Bro, look at his stats from the other series. Like, he probably played better in that series than the other dynamic duo of dog shit
in the last, like, 2 months.
Mm-mm. Yeah, I mean, listen, man, at least. Actually, I don't even know. I was going to say at least they're trying, but they're also just, like, their comms is just, like, strictly call-outs, you know, not really no small talk or nothing, you know. They're just kind of just, like, I feel like it's always Big P that's trying to get shit going.
He was frying, dude.
Yeah, I mean there was a point where he had, like, 30 kills, and I think the next one up was, like, 18, like, 19. Like, he was in the 30s, and nobody was even at the 20 mark yet. I'm like, dude, this guy's trying to do everything.
It might have been a last-ditch effort of them trying to just switch some up.
Hey, bro,
sure.
But look at Look at this, though. Like, it's 150 to 150 here. Octane's popping a two-piece over rotation. It's not that far. You know, they're looking pretty good.
This is where it goes downhill.
And then it goes downhill, Jay. That's what I was about to say. And then
they all
here...
spawned right there. All
Wait,
of Dallas spawned right
rotation?
There at AC.
Yeah.
Big Ender was frying, dude.
They got the two-piece, but they both held their cam, and they waited for that shit to pop, and then... They just spawned right there. They killed him out. They took control and they held us down. And this is the whole turning point. Illy really just started turning up to a whole nother level at this point.
I mean, at this point, Crims are already popping off as well.
Listen, I want to gas Ender real quick. I talked to the kid the other day. I told him, I said, listen, man, like, I'm not going to champs. I'm rooting for you. But if you're going to win, like, if you guys have a chance at winning, like, you're going to have to fry, bro. Because, like, Shotzi, that guy's disgusting. Like, you can count on him. Crims going to do his thing on land. And even Vivid, like, he's been playing good since he joined the team. And that guy's been doing his thing too. Like,
too.
If Ender plays good, they can win and they will have a good chance to win. So he understands
X-factor,
that.
Bro.
He understands that too. Like, he's like, yeah, I know. Like, I got to do my thing. Like, he understands that. And if he can do his thing, like, I think they'll be a favorite going forward.
Yeah, no, he played well today too. I mean, he's been playing well the last few weeks.
I feel like he's gotten better the last few weeks. But 100%. Before that, like, there's a little period where he was challenging.
Well, the first half of the game.
He still be doing some of that.
He still be challenging, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, come on, Illy.
He be doing that shit sometimes, you know what I'm saying? But, like, if he plays good, I think they'll have a good chance to win.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 100%. I mean, it comes down to, like, their superstar players. I mean, the Dallas, their superstars need to play good. I mean, that's part of being a superstar, is stepping up and showing what you're capable of. But I just think Shotzi, too. I was talking to Crim 6 yesterday. That guy's a fucking maniac.
That guy's different.
Dude, his
bro.
Engagements kill me, bro. He's always got, like, the most engagements on the squad, bro. He plays so
good. Guy's flying.
Yeah. He's nuts, man. He's nuts. And you know him, bro. He's just fucking, he's crazy. He's definitely getting these guys on the right track, though. One thing you can't take away from Crim is, you know, getting these guys on the right track and making sure these guys are playing the right way. You know him. And Crim's also a good teammate, too. You know, he might be a little fucking nuts. But he is a good teammate, and he'll always listen to you and hear you out. And, you know, one thing I like about Crim, or at least what I play with him, like, he's a fucking asshole when he talks to you, but you also can say something back to him, and he could be like, yeah, like, you might be right, you know, like, he'll fucking listen to you, where a lot of players struggle with that. You know, they'll get stubborn, or they don't want to hear anything. So I think, you know, Crimsy's got these guys on the right path. So just got to give some gas to him, because he's fucking, how old is he now, 35?
Go. 35 might be shit.
I think he's 1 year older than me. So
what's he, 27, 28?
28, maybe 29.
28, I don't know. I don't
he's getting
know,
up there, bro.
But he's getting up there, man. Along with
he's
playing
up there. He's not that old, bro. You guys are.
I mean, in terms of, we're talking strictly, you know, COD players. You know, I mean, bro, it is getting up there for a COD player.
For COD, sure. It's getting up there.
Yeah, 100%, bro.
Bro,
you're 30
I'll
years
argue
old.
This for so long.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm gonna go into the age.
He's gonna be the first. Like, we've never seen
if
it before.
If we were franchised in, like, 2010, bro, people would have been playing, and it wouldn't have.
That's true.
Yeah,
like it just wouldn't matter. You'd have been able to do it longer.
The first, like, to make it to that age, though.
Yeah, I mean, one of them. Once, like you think him, Simp, you think Simp's not going to be playing if COD's still around? He's not going to be playing when he's like 26, 27.
Nah, he will.
Like, yeah, dirty. But it's just the Phil's franchise.
This is my argument to that, right? This is my argument. It's not about how they're playing or their age. Like, it has nothing to do with age. It's about how long they've been doing it and if they want to keep doing it because the lifestyle, man, of being a professional player.
That's fair.
It drains you. Like, the amount of time you put into it, the lifestyle, you're always sitting on your ass. You're always fucking in front of a monitor for hours on hours a day. And then the pressure, the stress, like, it's just like, I think that's what happened to Clay.
But you'll miss it. You'll miss it.
You'll
after
miss it.
Six
yeah,
months,
yeah,
you'll
yeah,
miss
you'll
it.
You'll miss it, but the burnout will fucking kill you. I don't know, and I heard you like the retired life.
I did. I love it. I mean, I still love
still
it. But
love
I,
it,
I will say, dude, I miss competing 100%. I mean, like, there's yep, nothing 100%. Better.
You can't replace that shit, bro.
I think, for me, it's like when I'm watching it is when I miss it the most. You know, you're watching it and you're
yeah.
like...
Yeah, well, I watch it every
shit.
Day, so...
Yeah, and that's when you miss it the most. I mean, I watch it every day, too. You know, I can't do the show unless I watch the matches. So
yeah.
when I'm watching it, I'm like, damn, you know, I fucking miss this shit. Especially because I'm watching players that I played against, you know?
I don't miss
and
scrimmage.
You know you better than a lot of these
yeah,
guys still
I mean,
in there.
I mean, listen, I can make the comeback. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, the flank must go on. So I've been watching and I definitely miss it. So I definitely feel you on that. But listen, there's a lot of young guys who have been coming up that deserve spots, and they've been doing their fucking thing. A lot of these young guys, man, can fucking play, bro. I mean, they're good.
Oh yeah, they're nasty, man. They put in the time. And also, I gotta say, Temp, you're doing a great job at your new career, bro. He's killing
it. It's not my new career, bro.
Yeah, no.
I've been frying, bro. Listen, I've been losing. I'll get back to winning soon.
I like that, Don. You never
I'll get
give
back
up.
To a winning situation next year.
I bet. I miss
like
seeing you shine, brother.
But I've been frying. Check
yeah,
the stats.
I mean,
check the
yeah,
games.
Yeah,
I've been
yeah.
frying.
Go fucking check the stats. Breaking point, bitch. Go
I just been
it
losing. Hey, you know, it sucks. When you lose, it don't matter. But I've been doing my thing. I've been grinding,
mean, yeah.
too. So.
I swear, you guys are the best of, like, the ass teams, though. Like, you guys.
Oh, yeah. It's not even close.
It's not
we
even
have
close.
The best
yeah.
We have, like, the best, like, in my opinion, we have
Paris,
the best
Paris
players individually.
London.
Yeah, for sure.
Paris
what?
Or London?
Paris,
100%. London may have better teamwork than us. Like, we're about to play them, so I'm not going to, like, I'm just being honest. Like, they might have better teamwork than us. Like, they may be less chalked than us, but, like, gunny for gunny, they can't fuck with us. I dropped 9,500 on Alex. Like,
oh,
mother,
wait.
Like,
Alex
yeah,
Alex
yeah.
starting
gunny,
on a
gunny,
roster
like,
is mind-blowing right now. Yeah. He is not good at this game.
Gunny for gunny, they're not touching us, for sure.
Yeah, no, you guys definitely got the
we
gunny.
I'll take that. We're ninth seed. Best of the worst.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
yeah
for
yeah,
sure.
Best of the worst. Listen, I want to give some credit to it before. Yo, I want to give some credit to Vivid right here. I like the play he makes, bro. He's got fucking big ass cojones.
This was nasty. It was all on Illy. Illy threw this flash. Back. Perfect timing. Look, pops up. He's completely blind. He got to change up. Vivid hits
you
immediately.
Gotta,
that's teamwork
that
right there.
That was
baby.
A glitchy flash.
That was glitchy.
Hey, that was some ghost shit right there, bro.
Yeah, that was
elite.
That was fucking sick. Who the fuck are these guys?
Who the fuck?
Jesus.
Who the fuck is that guy, bro?
He's
throwing
bro.
Knuckleballs at the window. You have Neptune throwing curveballs at a yellow, and you have Ender throwing knuckleballs from top brown. It's crazy, bro. I mean,
that was some CS
but,
shit,
but
dude.
That was like my go-to too. Like whenever I wanted to hit something, be like, yo, fucking work something at this bitch. I'm about to push.
You did say that a lot.
Or like, yo, shoot at him. Like, back him down. I'm about to push him. Like, I would wait till somebody tagged him or backed him down, and then I'd fucking hit it. Like, that was like the go-ahead.
Yep.
And that's my man Reese. I wonder who taught him that shit. I gotta talk to him. But he fucking hits right through mid. He makes a play, and then it just opens it up, man. He even if he dies here, it doesn't fucking matter. He opened it up on offense. He gets the kill. Now Seattle's scrambling. They don't know what the fuck's going on. They start losing full. The trades are going down everywhere. And they win the offense. Shotzi's in the spawn. He's dipping and weaving. He's doing 360s and shit. You know what Shotzi does. And Dallas take the fucking the S&D. We go into a
control. What a round.
Great round. I love how Dallas is making plays, taking risks. Definitely good plays out of them. And then we go into the control. Dallas, they end up going up 2-0. Or Seattle, I'm sorry, goes up 2-0. And then they lose it.
Really? I didn't even peep.
Yeah, they went up 2-0.
And they was quick rounds too, Don.
Yeah, Seattle on this offense, they came out and they just...
They
it
took
was going
care
crazy.
Of business.
Like, Pristini was going nuts by
but
his lonely.
But then what happened, Jay? What happened to these Seattle guys?
They turned
I don't
Seattle.
Know. Dallas Empire just turned up. They responded quick with another offense on the very next round. And it was like, oh, snap. Hold up. They woke up finally.
Then it was just back-to-back defenses for Dallas. You know you got to take care of those.
Yeah, no, 100%. I think, you know, Seattle, they do a good job. Persini does a good job finessing, like you said, Jay.
Yep.
And just yeah. dipping and weaving and being annoying. And these are the plays you want to see out of players like this. And Persini's another one, too, man. Like, bros, Persini's a good player. Like, yeah. some of these Seattle players, you know, they're not bad players. It's just not clicking for these guys. Some of them have struggled individually.
Oh, my.
I think for the most part, Jesus fucking Christ, this guy's nuts. He's going crazy. I think, bro, once you get that 8.2 on Garrison, it's looking pretty good if you get the 8.1 first. Because then at this point, they got him in a blender. Dallas, they're trying to do everything they can.
Well, it's nice because right after you get it, you have bricks, right? And you just
the biggest thing, though, the biggest thing was that.
What the fuck is this? Hold on. 4 green?
Yeah, that's kind of nuts. They were all baiting for Persini, though. Nah, they were baiting for Persini.
They were trying to get him some streaks. And he died!
Wait, did he get him?
No,
nah,
he died!
He didn't get him. That's the thing.
What the fuck was that?
Trying to get my man
a
streak.
That's a
nubsy
call.
We're up 2-0.
That's some troll shit. I ain't gonna lie.
There's no way in hell that Big P called out Ford Green. It had to be somebody else.
That was a nubsy call. 100%. No, I'm trolling.
You think so?
I'm trolling.
I mean, they did get B for free.
They just wanted him to get a streak, man. They're up 2-0. They're like, we could take a risk.
Yeah, we get these streaks is basically.
I would never do that, but I get where they're coming from.
Look at Dallas! Look how easy they break. How the fuck did? What is Seattle doing right here? What the fuck is this?
Remember last year, I always say Gunrunner is a Halo map. H5,
H5.
You don't let Shotzi play the H5 map,
never,
bro.
Never.
This is one of them. You can mantle on everything. You can finesse everything. Get it out.
Don, remember I used to start saying it mid map. I'm doing the H5, Don. I'm doing the H5.
Literally, bro. You got that from Shots. He just runs backwards. He starts mantling on everything, and you can't trade him.
Bro, when he's over by what vents, bro, or by caution, and he's finessing, dude, it is terrifying. Do you remember that clip of him sliding back and forth in dark?
Yeah, door,
bro.
Yeah.
He's annoying as fuck.
My God.
Wait till next year. I heard there's going to be doors detonating shit. You got to detonate a door.
He's going to abuse that.
Who the fuck knows what he's going to do with that? But what the fuck? Why is Seattle playing like such pussies here? Let's be honest.
Yeah, they're like not pushing. Yeah, I don't get it. Nobody's
on
the tank.
My team does this shit too, and it's so bad.
Bro,
it's
when you turtle up, chalk it up, man. Look
at
him.
You turtle up, you lose one gunfight, you
lose
the game,
first of all, bro, this is so little, but you rarely see people doing this shit. I mean, look at this. He jumps up. He jumps over to the box.
Nah, everyone does that.
They do this now?
Yo, T.
Nah, everyone does that now.
You sure?
You still gas it, though. Perfect movements. Perfect movement.
But bro, right here, he doesn't need the mantle this shit. Now he can jump the corner. Bro, I know everybody can do it, but people actually being in a match and actually doing it. You know what I'm saying? I feel like people don't do it that much. I don't
like the turtling shit, bro. You know why? Because I would much rather force a gunfight into Shotzi rather than him forcing the gunfight into me when he's going to finesse a doorway, like trying to finesse into bricks. Like, it's way too easy for him to just get those kills like that.
Yeah, and then this shit's over. I mean, they win
and
the
then
offense.
It's just over. Yeah, you give yourself one chance. They kill you, you're done.
Yep, and then Dallas, they win the offense in 2 seconds. They go back to the defense. They close it out. It's Garrison defense.
To comment on one more thing on that. If you see how Toronto do it in that situation, one of their ARs, Camier Insight, always wrap right. So where if any sub players go square, they're getting mowed down into a crossfire.
At least weak, right?
You just need one person to wrap far right. Even a sub can do it. But if an AR does it, they're not just going to run through your mid and break you instantly.
Nope. And then we have we have these guys. They got him in the Toronto trap now. They got him in the Toronto trap. They can't
go
anywhere. Look at Krim,
bro. He's balling.
And then next thing you know, it's fucking over. It's all over.
Shotzi just plays the right way.
Yeah, thank you, Z. I appreciate you coming in.
He plays the right way.
See, you say this every time.
Nah, he
does. How's it going? Nice to meet you.
No,
yo,
Don,
what's up,
don't guess that, Don. Z says that about everybody.
Shotzi does play the right way.
Every time somebody fries, Z comes in here and goes, honestly, man, he plays the right way.
I only say that about, like, Shotzi, Abizi, and Simp.
Okay.
That's it? Those are the only people that play the right way?
Yeah, that's the only thing.
Yo, who's Z?
Damn,
what's up, bro? Nice
I met
to meet
Z. So crazy story about Z. I met Z through GTA RP. That's how I met Z, and we've been great friends ever since. We talk every day.
What's your code name on GTA, Z?
Z.
Z.
That's it?
Yeah, his name's Z. It's his fucking name.
Is that all we know about him?
People say I look like you, Nameless.
Oh, you're handsome as fuck then, huh?
Hey.
Let me see a picture of you, buddy.
Wait, you actually kind of do look like Nameless, no cap.
Let me see a picture of this guy.
Nah, I look like Oliver Queen. You guys seen Arrow?
Who the fuck is that, then?
Nah, I don't
look like that guy at all. There's no way.
Listen, see, I don't know who the fuck that is.
It's the guy from the Green Arrow, bro.
Yeah.
Guy's handsome.
Oh, really? I don't know. But let's go into some predictions. We got London Royal Ravens going up against the Paris Legion. That match
listen,
gonna
dude,
suck.
It's going say, five. Listen,
wait, that match might be lit.
Wait, no. Wait. This is the battle. This is what the battle we were just talking about, Don.
Yeah, if we win that match, we should make winners. That's crazy.
Wait, really?
Yeah, wait. If we win that match, we can make winners in 2 or 3. Look. I'll break it down. We win. No matter how, if we win game 5 round, it don't matter. We just got to win. If Optic beat the Thieves, which, come on now, like, they're 4-0, like, they can't just talk. You know what I'm
Optic
like,
might
just go
troll.
Optic honestly should bully them. So if Optic
you
beat the Thieves,
you
and then FaZe beat New York,
head-to-head, yeah,
we're
you're
good.
Right.
So
oh,
we're going dumb.
Shit,
like,
let's
I'm
get
with,
it,
Don. Let's get it, Don. Let's
I'm
get it.
I'm going to 8 a.m. and I'm getting turned.
Oh, shit. Is,
we don't even play till 3 Eastern, but I'm still getting turned.
On a real note, dude, honestly, like, I feel like what we've seen from Afro, he's been solid. And then also, like, Paul X, he's starting to play better again. Dude, Alex has got to step it up, man. I know I've been
for
really
real,
hurting him this,
man.
But Buddy has been getting tucked in, like, all their series, dude. He's got to step up in the series.
He had one good series, and unfortunately,
yeah, he popped
New York
versus New York in that one.
Yeah, but then he bounced
Jay.
Back right back.
But
to,
overall,
you know, I'm
bro,
sad too, Tom.
I know.
But yeah, nah, his consistency is like where they need to find it.
I don't
right
get
now,
it. Why
like,
did they not keep Zed? Like Zed
yeah,
was playing.
Zed was the man.
Yo, they were at
Zed
their best
the
with
man.
Him for sure.
Yeah, it blows my mind.
And they still never brought him in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can they still bring him in now? Even with Russell up because they have Zed on the bench, they can bring him in, right?
They should bring Zed back in.
He's the guy sneaking ninjas. Like, the guy's got some cojones on him.
No, Zed was unselfish.
Zed had
I mean,
some
that's amazing.
Yeah.
That's what made him a
like
good player.
Some...
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
I mean, bro, why do the unselfish players always get the fucking can? I don't understand.
I think they thought Alex had a higher ceiling,
which
when they made the change, I didn't, like, disagree with it. I'm like, oh, yeah, Alex used to be pretty good. He's got high ceiling. But we've had enough sample size now. Put his ass on the bench.
It's
get
like
him
the
on
same
the pine.
Thing with Alex. Or, with, not Alex, with Asim. You know, like, he wasn't getting picked up. Bro, in the beginning of the year, Asim was fucked. If I didn't get him on New York, he was done. And I had to go on my fucking, I had to beg on my knees to get Asim on the team. And we finally got him on a team. Like, a player like Asim almost didn't make the cut. Because he's one of those players who's unselfish. He is flashy at
everyone
times.
Everyone looks at KD, bro.
But they all look at that shit. Yeah. Like, they all look at that shit. And, like, when is that going to stop? When is that ever going to fucking stop in COD? Like, it makes no sense to me. And
probably now.
Any top player, anybody who knows COD can watch the game and tell you who's good and who's bad and without looking at a stat sheet. It doesn't even fucking matter. You could tell by the plays they make on the map, which is why I was mind blown when this guy didn't get on the team. And Asim was devastated too at the time. He was like, dude, I don't get it. Like, I was so unselfish doing my thing. I was making plays. Like, fucking, I think he was arguably the best player on Minnesota last year for sure. I was like, I don't know, kid. But I want you on my team, and we got him. And look at what he's been doing, you know?
He's been doing his thing.
He's missed the do-it-all right now.
Yeah, bro. He's got engine. He's doing the IGL shit now. He's been switching guns all year. You know, it's like this kid's going through it. You know, he's had to deal with a lot of shit. You know, the visa shit.
Man.
Took a step back. Clay took a step back now. Like, it's just like, you know. So my
props
out to him.
I respect him, like, tremendously, man, because every single match, regardless of everything that he's been through this entire year, he's always wearing his heart on his sleeve, man. He's always out there, the most passionate, getting everybody, trying to rile the fellas up. Like, he's that guy for that team, man. I really love his team.
Yeah, I mean,
somebody
put Engineer with a laughing face. Engineer with a sub is, like, not common, is it not?
Engineer with a sub? That's the only thing.
Yeah,
I mean, it is harder to run, but, ARs don't run it.
Mm-mm. Yeah, I mean, I guess he's that one guy. It says everybody has that one guy on their team.
Yeah, everyone has that one guy.
Yeah. So Asim's that guy. You know what I'm saying? So he's been doing his thing, man. So shout out to Asim. Shout out to you guys in New York.
Who you got, Tommy, in Ravens Legion?
Be honest, dude.
No, I'm gonna be honest. I got Paris. I think it'll be a good match though. I don't think it's gonna be like a blender. Like I think it's gonna be a blender.
I think it's 3-1 Paris.
I'm going 3. Yeah, I was gonna go 3-1. I'm going 3-1. I can see some of the maps being closed, but I think Paris will come out on top here and take them down. But we'll see. Who do you got? You guys all agree? Do we all agree on that?
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm going 3-2 Paris.
3-2 Paris?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I feel like Maddie's gonna clutch up.
Yeah. Well, you know,
my man Maddie.
You know us, Z Tank. You know that guy's a different beast.
Yeah.
You know
yeah.
What I'm saying?
He's built different.
Yeah.
I need this picture. Tweet me.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah. Tweet him a picture. I'll pull it up. And then we got the Florida Mutineers going up against the Minnesota Rocker. This might be a good one.
That one should be a good one, man.
Hopefully.
I'm expecting that one to be great because both of these guys coming off of some tough L's.
They know how important that matchup is to definitely try to get into winners and stuff like that. So,
yeah, bro.
That one's going to be big, man.
What's What are the group standings there? I'm just going to go look at
the group Dallas and they got Ultra.
Bro, I don't think that match is going to be that good.
You don't think so? I feel like Minnesota and Florida
is going to win like 3-1. Matt, like, the worst.
Know, man. Oh, this is a fight for third. Right?
Yeah, this is a fight for third.
I think Florida, honestly, I think Florida could 3-0.
You think so?
Their S&D's looking good. Florida's hard point. They still get down to the wire. Yeah, I mean, Donnie could be right.
Everyone's got to pick their own thing. That's just my, you know what I'm saying? I'm just
Florida 3-0. Listen, it depends what kind of Minnesota we're getting, man. These guys are all over the place. It depends.
They're the hardest team to predict, dude.
Yeah, they're the hardest team to predict. You just don't know what the fuck they're going to come out with. I mean, it's like they're so inconsistent. I mean, when they're on, they're on. You know, they have talent on the team. I could definitely see these guys making a series. I'll go 3-1.
Yeah, I think Florida wins.
I'll go 3-1 Florida.
I'm going opposite, fellas.
You going rocker. Minnesota? I like that, Jay. Yeah. I like that a lot.
Just like,
I hope
today,
Rocker.
These
I'm
guys
rooting for Rocker.
6 points on their best hard point.
Yeah,
it
you're
was 6-0.
Right. You're right.
Yeah, it's 6 points.
Why are we giving these guys credit?
And
wait, Florida is better than
Rocker. By six kills.
Point,
sixes everywhere.
We'll see, man.
We'll see.
I mean, looking at Rocker, what are they? I mean, they're 2-4 in their last six matches.
Wait, so Jay, you think Rocker's
and
the
they've only beaten Surge and Gorillas? It's like it's not like Rocker's had crazy wins.
Come out and win the hard point.
Really?
I think the S&D is gonna be okay. What are you talking about?
All right, Florida today.
What kind of Florida are we gonna get tomorrow? Is the real question.
I'm gonna go 3-1 Florida.
3-0 Minnesota.
Okay, holy shit.
Listen, man, Minnesota could come out and do something. I don't know, but we'll see. But I think we're all different here. Don, who do you got? You got Florida 3-1?
I got Florida 3-0.
Oh, 3-0? Okay, I got Florida 3-1. Jay went fucking Minnesota 3-2. And you went with who?
Florida 3-1.
Okay, we'll see. Listen,
actually, I'm going to do Florida 3-1 because I'm going to do a 3-0 for the next one.
Okay, cool. And then Optic LATs, you're going 3-0 Optic?
Go 3-0 Optic.
I got my pick 'em already locked. I did it the first day, 3-0 Optic.
Bro, yep. I was gonna say 3-0 Optic. I think it's gonna be
3-1. I think it'll be 3-1 Optic.
What map they win? What map did the Thieves win?
Maybe an S&D. Maybe a control. They, I don't know.
Nah, they might be able to sneak a hard point out. I don't know.
They're gonna eat them up, bro.
That's what I'm hoping. Yeah, they might be able to
first map. They're gonna start up 1-0 and lose three straight.
Yeah.
COD's interesting, man. LATs might come out and play the best COD they've ever played in their life.
Yeah, LA Thieves suck.
Okay.
This one's tricky. Right. The green ball.
I think this is a match. Envoy runs around freely, but I'm just going to go off.
My prediction, so I don't know what to
say
here.
The way I'm looking at it is Seth and Envoy, honestly,
they're
going to
be going off, bro.
They've been frying recently as like a sub duo. They might be the best sub duo right now.
Whoa.
They might be. Simp and Abizi, okay, all right, you got to give it to him. But listen, they've been frying. Wait, they've been frying. Everybody's running up mid-map.
Yes,
like,
they've
been frying, bro. That's all I'm trying to say. They've been frying, and Thieves may have, like, one of the lower, like, probably the worst subduel out the teams that go in the champs. I don't know what you guys think, but, like,
Jaws is nasty. He just got to work.
Even versus, like, when they play my team, like, we could just fuck them up bad. Like, I don't know, like. Mm-hmm. I just feel like they have no chance of beating them at hardpoint right now.
Whoa. Z looks nothing like me. You're a nice looking fella, but.
I didn't say it. Ian says it. Enable.
You look like Enable.
What?
What?
You look like fuck? You look a little bit like Enable, just not as white.
Did you tweet him, Z? Oh, I see it. I see it. All right, we're going to pull it up. No, you kind of.
I got Optic 3-0.
You look like a baby Nameless. You look like a young Nameless.
Wait, where's the picture?
I pulled it up. If you didn't have that beard, I can see the double chin behind there, brother.
And he looks like Bobby too.
Yeah. He looks like Nameless and Rated, bro.
He does. Yeah, he does, bro.
I don't know.
I look like Oliver Queen.
No, you don't.
What do you mean?
Who the heck is Oliver? Let's look it up. Oliver Queen.
Hey, how old are you, Z?
20. Z, you do not.
My hairline wasn't that good at 20, about. So.
Yeah, Z, you look at that. What the fuck are you talking about, Z?
Yeah.
Oliver Queen. Get a fucking grip, Z. You know what I'm saying? Z, you're a good looking guy, but you don't look like Oliver Queen. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I don't know.
Somebody said, looks like Nameless in Fire 40.
Yeah, he does, right?
Listen, man, I think Optic's gonna come out and win 3-0, maybe 3-1. Maybe I'll let these takes a fucking map.
My duo, baby.
But I think, yeah, Soap and Skump are the duo now. They play league play and shit together. It's a whole superstition. But Skump has not played league play with you today, Soap.
Not today, no.
So if you don't get any games in, I might have to switch it up and go 3-0 LA Thieves.
I don't like this.
I don't know.
Guy.
The Thieves are still pretty bad.
Yeah, why don't you like them, man? Speak up. What's the problem?
He never admitted to it because he's a coward, but I think he booted me from this TeamSpeak once.
Whoa.
Soap, you booted him from the TeamSpeak?
Me?
No
I think
way.
I think it was Soap, yeah.
I might have did it. I'm an asshole. What do you expect?
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You going to right. Champ, Soap?
Yeah, I'll be Ooh. There when it was happening.
Oh, just come say what up.
I'll come say what up for sure.
Sounds good, brother.
He'll probably be faded off the papaya, but he'll be there.
I'll be there.
We might all be. But let's get into some of this Reddit shit. Unless there's anybody that disagrees.
I feel like you guys didn't talk about, like you guys didn't actually like go into it. Like, that's like the big match.
I
that's like a dope match.
I mean, I think.
You're right. You know what? You're right, co-host.
You're
going to
get fried. You're
right, co-host.
Yeah, game your matchup. Like, we're just like getting fried.
You're right.
Time for Reddit?
You're right, Don. You're right. See, that's why we brought you on here today, Don, to make sure that everything's in check. And that's exactly what you're doing. I think Optic has just been looking good. I think I was talking to Seth a little bit. They definitely been working really hard. I think even just looking at the process and looking at the video and just seeing their work ethic as a team, I think these guys are just on the right path of just being the best. And then on top of that, they have the momentum, the confidence. Like, they have everything going for them right now. And I think besides for Simp and Abizi, I still think Simp and Abizi are up.
Yeah, you gotta give it to him, bro. I was faded.
They're number one.
Sure. I think Seth and Envoy are just working
number
really
two.
They're working good off each other right now, man. It's a good balance. Yeah. I think the one thing that I noticed is they're not scared to make plays and take risks anymore. Like, I feel like
finally.
Big, yeah, yep. Finally. Yeah, I mean, that was like a big play back like a month ago, but now I just feel like their confidence is on another level. Like, these kids are just feeling good. You know what I'm saying?
But that being said, Jay, what first map, Hardpoint or the Thieves, going to win? Visualize the vetoes.
It might not be a Hardpoint, but I think they might sneak one in. It might be
Where,
what map
they're
you
not
think?
Gonna,
like,
they're not
going to
win. I guess they could possibly win the S&D, but even then, yeah, they're going to lose 3-0-3-1. I don't see a world where Optic loses this match just because looking at this Optic roster, bro, they're playing so confident now.
They are.
Like, even Dashy, he was absolutely on point. He's making the right plays. Their comms even got better. Skump has been feeling it. Envoy was fucking making play calls and that listening on that raid. It was just disgusting. Mm. Like they were a unit. They were a pure team.
Bro, also,
I don't think Thieves takes it.
Yeah, but I don't expect the Thieves to be the same team that we saw at their last match. Like, they've only have a little bit of time to work with. So the more time that they get, they're going to look better. And obviously, they know that this is a big match. They know they got to go out and show something because they got destroyed by FaZe. But they have to
by
come
us.
Up. Yeah, and they lost to y'all as well. Like, that's
They played decent versus that, they lost to us? Bad.
Yeah, that was unacceptable.
Unacceptable.
But they need to have an answer. So they're going to have to come out, and they're going to have to show something. You know, the practice got to make its way to the main stage.
I don't know, man. When I look at the rosters, it doesn't – like, I wasn't, like, when Paris beat LATs, I wasn't mind-blown. Is that weird for me to say?
I was mind-blown, and I won. Okay. I won a game chat right. As we won the last match. I said, Jesus Christ, son.
They probably lost full.
Like,
they
bro, wait, if you're
full.
Trying to win, if you're trying to win an event and you're playing against our team, we're supposed to be a free dub, like a free.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. Like,
that is true.
We gotta just close these guys out and move on to the next one. Like, we're going into that shit. I'm just shooting. Like, we just shooting our gun. We didn't give a damn.
I mean, fuck it. You know what I'm saying?
It's a whooping.
They got it. But I'm saying, that's what I'm saying. Like,
hey, I got sources that tell me LATs haven't even been performing
in Chicago
well
is turned.
Scrims. Have they been playing well in scrims? Because my sources are Fugaze.
Who?
Like Thieves. How have they been playing in scrims?
We haven't played them.
Oh, you haven't played them?
Last time we scrimmed them was the day after we beat them and we 5-0'd them and just got off.
Oh, shit.
I was texting Cap. I'm like, Cap, if you guys aren't going to try, I'm just going to get the fuck off, bro. No bullshit.
Holy shit.
Whoa. Whoa. Just get the fuck off line, bro.
Yeah,
but
fuck.
They should play better versus another team. Like, they might have a mental block. I don't know what it is versus us, but
I think it might be you, Don.
It might be.
Yeah, bro. Well, you know, the marksman, when he's on point. You know?
It might be. I don't
Forget
know.
Forget about it. I think it's going to be a good day anyway, because we just got some big names, right? We got a lot of big name players playing tomorrow. Got some good teams. I think it could get interesting, but we'll see. I think regardless, we have a good understanding of these teams now.
This might be a 9-0 day.
Maybe.
No cap.
It could be. But we never know what. Listen, Call of Duty, you don't know, man. You don't know what the fuck's going to happen. Let's be honest. So I'm excited for tomorrow. We finally got three matches, so we got a little bit more COD to watch. And I also don't know if Ben is going to be joining us tomorrow because I think he's still on vacation. I don't know what the fuck he's doing over there. But
this guy, where'd he go? Went on a rogue vacation?
Don't even get me started.
I didn't even know he was leaving. It's my golf.
Not coming here Sunday either.
Yeah. I don't know what's going on.
We're supposed to go golfing.
I don't know.
I thought Ian was on for tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll probably get Ian on. Well, Don plays tomorrow, so Don, I don't even know if you would even want to come on.
I can get on. I could do it.
But listen, dude, Temp is doing a fantastic job today. He's doing a great job.
He's preparing himself. I love it, Don.
And I appreciate you coming on last minute too.
Bro, stop saying that shit, bro. Just gas. I'll take the gas, but don't say prepare yourself, bro. I am playing good. Don't try to send me out, bro. I'm gonna start tweeting out my stats. Because I already see other people saying that shit. I'm competing next year, and I will be back in a winning situation.
Don, you would make a wonderful on-air talent, brother.
No,
wonderful,
bro.
Don.
Listen, you got the smile, the charisma.
I'm going to fry, bro. I'm going to be where I need to be.
You even got the frown, dude.
This is what I want to see from more COD pros. Post more clips, man. Post more scoreboards. Start talking some... Bro, I used to do that shit.
It gotta get spicy.
Bro, fuck that. You pop a 10-piece, post that shit on Twitter. Say, I just smoked these motherfuckers and monetize it. And fucking post that shit. And fucking show off what you got. Because, listen, a lot of people, they got to see you play, man. You know, like, a lot, especially going into next year. Like, I feel like clips and shit like that. Like, teams actually care about that shit, man. Like, start building brands. Start posting fucking shit. Start posting pictures. I saw Zinni post a scoreboard the other day. I said, okay, well, here goes Zinni. But, you know
how it is. How do you do? How's the team doing?
Hydra had his post up there in the intro for dumb long.
They were getting shit on?
Well, I mean, the scoreboard, he was doing good. The one scoreboard he took
out.
But I've been watching them the last couple of days. They haven't looked the best.
Brother. It's tough for my boys then. Miss them.
Well, I mean, they haven't played in the tournament. We'll see what happens tournament time. You know, I don't really want to look too into scrims or a new team. But we'll see what happens. You know, I wish them the best. But let's get into the flank Q&A. I posted something on Reddit. You guys obviously came in hot. The first one of the day is, how's Joel doing? We're gonna ignore that one. Joel lost his mod ship yesterday. He got into a little bit of
an... We got thunderclapped by Scump, right?
He got into an altercation with Scump. Joel went rogue, and he lost his mod ship. Listen, guys, I have no problem.
Shit.
Listen, I unmodded everybody yesterday, and I did a full clean mod wipe because my mods were acting up.
Am I not modded?
You might not be, but if you're not, you're gone.
Founder.
But here, let me mod you again. I unmodded everybody, so I have to remod people. So don't take it the wrong way, but I just modded.
That's all good, bro.
I'm still popping.
But you're still good. Some people I caught. Some people I caught when I was doing it. But listen, man, mod wipe. I want to make sure that nobody's messing around in the chat. Listen, if people want to talk shit, be toxic in the chat, I really don't give a fuck. But it's what Seth said, man. If you're a moderator and you got that green sword next to your name in my chat, you got to be professional. All right? I can't have nobody acting up. Not with that green sword next to your name. Wear that shit with honor, guys.
Go to the next question, bro.
For Tommy, fuck, marry, kill. Wait, what? With whoever's in the call at the moment, if there's only two people, throw soap into the mix. Interesting.
Look at me.
Okay, so what are the three people for me? Somebody give me the three in here. What should I do? Donnie, Nameless, and Jay? Should I do that?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. Then. I'm killing Nameless for sure. I'm going to get
Wait, why would you kill me?
Because you made shit stressful for me on the come up, bro. Stressful.
I was the fuel to your fire.
You were the fuel to my fire. I'll give you that, but you have to go, because then
you
I
think
got.
It's gonna be that easy to kill me, brother?
Listen, I'm answering the fucking question. Ant. All right.
I'm joking. Go ahead.
Nameless is gone, and then I got Donnie and Jay. This is where things get tough, but you know Jay's a good looking guy, so I'll fuck him. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm just no weird shit, guys. I just answered the question. You know. And then I lived with Don already, so I got to marry Don. You know, we'll move in together. And there you go. That's my answer.
What a dysfunctional marriage that was. Wow.
Well, we work great together, bro.
All right.
So Don, did you do the dishes? I'm screaming.
All right.
That's Chow. We will get to the bread and have a maid.
Someone said
point.
Ben's getting smoked.
Oh, my.
Listen, man.
Next question.
Ben's getting smoked. Scroll down.
Listen, man. Now you guys got to go. Don, you're up. Me and Jay.
All right, I'll do it, and then we got to move on to the next one.
Yeah, right. I can't answer this.
All right, I'm married, Tom. I'm killing Ann. I'm fucking Jay. You got a little thicky.
Oh, shit!
He got a little thicky.
Wait, hold on. My girlfriend's in the chat. Lose a composure.
Guys, Guys, why am I not getting any Marys here? Got a house to
I'm
take
sorry,
care of it.
Babe,
Jay just got a low-key wagon.
It's just for the question, babe.
Jay has a...
It's just for a question.
He's got a low-key wagon. He does, he does, he does.
All right.
Next question.
We might
I'd
need
be
to
killing
get...
Jay instantly.
Listen, let's get to the next one, okay? Let's get to the next one. Where do you see COD salaries going? Do you see a point where salaries will start decreasing if the results aren't there and if veterans start retiring? Do you think having 8 to 12 yearly tournaments is more viable for the scene?
Oh, he's biting off a lot.
Yeah, let's just answer the first one. Where do you see COD salaries going? Do you see a point where salaries will start decreasing if the results aren't there and if veterans start retiring? 100,000,000%, yes.
Yeah.
For
yeah.
sure.
Going to go down next year, I would assume.
I think there's players who are overpaid. I think there's players who are underpaid. I think it's just going to come down to who you are. I just think a lot of young talent's going to be coming up throughout the years. I just think that's how it is. I think there's just a lot of good young talented players. And, you know, when you can give some of these guys the minimum, they're going to take it. And then I think there's also players who are probably going to switch teams or maybe not have a team. They're going to be forced to take what they get. You know what yeah. I'm saying? And a lot of these organizations are going to try and save as much money as possible. That's just how it goes. You know what I'm saying? So I could definitely see it happening for sure. I can. But we'll see. What do you guys think? You guys agree with me on that?
I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you said it well. There's not much else to say. It was great.
What do you say? Also, the last time you guys got a bit sensitive about my flare, but I'm only using it since Sharp was the reason I got into Comp COD. Sensitive about your flare. I don't give a fuck about the flare.
You
know what I'm saying?
Damn.
I don't give a fuck.
He's a big Kozdov fan.
I guess so. If you can make one roster change to Dallas, Toronto, and Optic to increase your probability of dethroning FaZe in the next game, what would it be?
You gotta grab a player from FaZe.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the only way, right?
You gotta break them up. Like.
Yeah, I agree. you gotta try and fucking offer him a bag. But even that, I don't think any of them would leave.
Nope.
I think trying to separate them, you gotta start trying to pull from, like, I don't know, maybe try and pull like Awakening in or Cam.
Nah, dude.
Nah, listen, those Toronto guys, man, those guys are up.
Yeah.
Their contract is up. I don't know what's gonna happen with those guys. Toronto better whip out the fucking bag. Toronto Ultra, yeah. It's time to pay up.
Take the Zinni bag and spread it across.
Oh, shit. That's fucked.
I mean, I'm being real though. This is gonna happen.
But Toronto, you gotta pay the fuck up, guys. You gotta pay the fuck up. So we'll see. And if you guys are wondering what this was just a black box that I downloaded so I can put Donnie's name. So a lot of people were like, "What the fuck is that?" But I just downloaded a picture. But let's go into the next one. Could you please try some Capture the Flag 8s with the boys sometime? I know it would be fun to watch.
Well, that would be lit.
Probably have a blast raid, standoff, apocalypse, Moscow. Hey, that would be fun.
I'm Wait, down, T.
Is Capture the Flag in this game?
I think it is.
I have no idea.
Do they have Capture the Flag in this shit?
I don't play no pubs.
It's in pubs. Oh, okay.
Oh, it is. We should do that. That does sound fun, Don. What? That sounds like fun.
ETF Classic.
And you're an
that's
active
where,
pro. We
that's
don't
where
get to
Classic
compete, bro.
Is really going to shine.
That's true.
But this goes to the next one. What's the best possible SMG duo you could form without using either Simp or a BZ?
Shotzi Envoy.
Shotzi Kleenex.
Bro, what about like a Shotzi Neptune or some shit?
Ooh.
Imagine
nah,
Shotzi
too similar, bro.
I think that.
Yeah, they are kind of
similar.
I think
Shotzi Nep.
I think Shotzi Envoy would be nasty.
Listen,
bro.
I had that argument, and I actually said that a couple weeks ago. I said I think Shotzi and Neptune might not work because it's too similar. But then I'm thinking, imagine if those guys just get in rhythm, like they hit that chemistry, like they figure it out. They would be annoying as fuck.
Hell yeah.
But I like Shotzi Envoy because Envoy's nasty at S&D, and then Shotzi has those tweak S&Ds as well, bro.
So
they'd be so good. No, I know, but I just like...
You can't go
I'm
wrong
not...
with either. There's no right answer.
Envoy brings so... Like, he's like a shot caller, bro. He's super smart. I don't know, yeah, there's no really wrong answer, but I would prefer the Envoy one.
And there's a lot of top subs too, man. You know, like, I think even not because he's my guy, Asim, you can pair Asim with one of those guys. Like, Asim and Shotzi might
work.
Be really good. Like I feel like Hydra you can throw in there. I mean, some of the New York guys, right? Or Envoy too. I think you could throw Envoy in. It depends. It's a playstyle thing too and how they would mesh with each other. Like, there's so many little things.
Reddit is so funny, bro. Who can shot the 100 goat?
let's see.
I got it, bro. Pristini and Classic. There we go. That'd be disgusting.
Alex and Classic.
That's fucked up, man.
That's fucked, man. What the fuck? Would pros want more events through the year and get rid of online? Of course.
Yes.
There would potentially 100%. Be less money per event and obviously more travel time. I mean, we used to travel every
1,000.
month. I was telling my girlfriend this. I think it was like a week or two ago. We used to travel all the time. We were on a plane like every 3 weeks. Were we not? We were always traveling to events, and it was so much fun, man. It was like that was like what made my job so fun. And then once that all went away, you know what clicked to me yesterday too.
I'm about to cut you off. Like how we said, the internet is super toxic. Like recently, I feel like when we used to go to like events and like see the fans and feel the love in person, like we wouldn't even like, not that we wouldn't care about the fans online, but like we wouldn't even see it as much. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
So that's why I feel like it feels more toxic now because we're not seeing that like in person like love. But it's still the same. 100%. You know what I'm saying?
100%. I agree with you. Yesterday on the show, Temp said he could see teams breaking GAs at champs. Do you think that this is actually a possibility, and what should be done if that happens?
That would be catastrophic in person.
What happens if somebody breaks GAs at champs? What the fuck?
No.
You lose respect.
The only thing I said was the artillery thing.
Yeah,
I got locked on.
That's crazy. That artillery guy was waiting 10 seconds.
All right, no, I was saying that. First of all, I didn't do it.
Yeah, Jay, what the fuck was that?
But I'm just saying that.
They're lucky we weren't in New York at that, but Jay.
That was kind of funny, dude. Like, fuck it.
Yeah, that was funny as fuck, though. That was funny as fuck.
I could see that happening on at Champs.
Oh, yeah, man?
I could see this next question is faded, dude.
Which pro player was the biggest rager, and what's their biggest rage moment?
I was thinking the next one.
Clayster.
No, Haggy was, bro.
Haggy was one. Clay. I mean, listen, we've all had different experiences with rage.
Yeah, that's true.
For me, I asked Clay how he jumped off the map, and he flipped the fuck up. Why the fuck do you always ask me that, dude? I said, no. I don't know, Clay. You're always falling off.
Can I ask you, T? Have you ever seen the RCXD video with Haggy? That is right there, the prime rage.
He's changed his ways,
but in his prime rage, dude, he was a force to be reckoned with, brother.
Haggy doesn't do that anymore, though. So I feel
the
like
video
you
of
him.
You and him as well arguing.
Oh, that was funny. Yeah, yeah. I went a little rogue though. You know,
out of the current pros, who would you say?
I mean, Krim is one of them. Slasher.
Slasher.
Play.
Yeah. I'm trying to think. What about Gunless?
In his heyday. Whew.
I feel like he's calmed down a little bit, though. I feel like Big P calmed down a bit. I don't know. Honestly, I don't know, because I don't know what he's like in scrims. But I feel like those are like the main guys, you know? Those guys are very out there.
I was a rager, too, though. I can't play innocent here.
Same. At times. When I was younger, I raged a lot. But then, you know, I think we grew out of it a little bit. Would you rather win 3 to 5 majors or win one major and COD champs? One major and COD champs.
Yeah, not even close. Guaranteed. Cement yourself in history.
Yeah, one major and COD. I mean, they're all going down into history. I mean, winning majors are cool.
But like
the ring is just spicy, you know.
Especially in this format, bro. It's on land.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's like, what do you guys think about the argument that champs is just another event?
That's cap.
Cap.
You think it's cap?
That's absolute cap. It's champs.
Super cap.
I feel like I've talked to people who've won champs, and when I ask them, like, how does it feel? They're like, I don't know. It just feels like another event.
You can have the shittiest year possible, and you can make it all up in one tournament at the end, which is the one.
Champs is different, brother.
Because of the pressure, period. Bro. It's just not, you can't even argue it.
I'm a world champ. If you get to say, I'm a world champion, that's different, period. Yep.
I'm a runner-upper. Sucks.
Yeah, when I got top three, I was so upset, bro. I was like, dude, when you get right there, Jay.
Yeah.
It was terrible.
I've had mixed feelings about that question, but just like after thinking about it more, I don't know. You guys are probably right.
It's just a perspective thing for sure, right?
It just depends, because if you're thinking about the World War II one, then like they can't say they were the best team in the game because they won champs.
But they're world champions, though,
but they
right?
still
like,
won champs.
Exactly.
Like,
That was my dub, right? They won the season, though, at the end. And that was like my argument to it, but
they're not the best team in that game. Not even, hell no.
Yeah, it is what it is.
They won champs.
Yeah, I guess it is what it is.
But that's also like a unique case, right? Yeah. It's like, dude, if you win champs, that's on your record forever, bro.
I used to counter argument that, but it was probably a dumb argument, bro. Somebody could probably find a clip of me fucking arguing it the other way. It's just another fucking event. But you know, I've thought about it a lot. It's one of those questions that I've thought about. Obviously, I would have loved the ring, man. I'm sure you guys would have loved one as well. You know, it's
100%.
It's one of those things too. I guess my argument to it was just like it never happened on that weekend. Like, it wasn't that...
But, T,
what?
You know what it is, bro? The big thing is like, every year you only get one chance to win champs, right. But every year you get a bunch of chances to win a major or win a tournament, right?
Yeah.
It's only one time every year to get a ring, so that's why it's different.
Right. No, 100%, 100%. That's probably just half the time me arguing, just me being salty, because you know I really wanted one. You know what I'm saying? But what are you gonna do? I'll just steal Crimson's fucking rings. Today, Call of Duty comp is filled with players slide canceling their brains out, which has caused the game to play faster and faster. Do you think this playstyle would work in older Call of Duties? No. For example, regardless of their gun skill and teamwork, would a team like FaZe be able to play like they do today back in Black Ops 2? No,
yeah,
I mean,
in
they would be
too,
disgusting.
Yeah.
They would be
Black
disgusting.
Black Ops 2, they'd be okay.
Because dexterity in Black Ops 2, yeah, you come out of sprint.
They got that come out of sprint.
And you could jump over shit.
But in terms of like jumping at people and being maniacs, no. But I'm saying like they would still be top team in the game for sure.
They're smart players too, bro. They're smart players. They'll be smart. The only 100%. Game it has to be like a drastic difference, like MW2.
Yeah,
if we hopped on MW2 playing them, they would just be like, they would obviously have to be like smart and learn the game, but it would be very easy to kill them because you just die in a bullet and you can just snake. Like, I could just snake them, you know? Like, it'd have to be a super drastic, like, difference between games. And yeah, BO2, you, like, you, can real, win. You can win gunnies.
You could be cracked in that game. And
you could
then,
be
like,
cracked in BO2.
Even a game like Ghost, you can kind of be cracked in it, at least the MTAR meta. Ghost, you can run
the
around.
The MTAR meta was hella fun.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the MTAR meta was fun.
I think T, you were fucking twisted in Ghost, right? Like, you were like one of the, you were like the best player at the very end. We're like one of the best players, top three.
Yeah,
and
we
you
were
just running around. So like,
you
could definitely
missing.
Shut
you,
the fuck
you
up.
Know,
Jay.
You know,
so you could definitely play that way in games like that.
You know
like
what's
the
crazy
old
too
ones,
about
though.
That is like, bro, people don't remember Ghost Zuma. Like they never really do.
Oh,
like,
here you go.
No, that was the craziest shit. Like, I'm saying,
same
like,
though, bro.
No, no, I'm saying, like, Nate Shot was even on stream the other day. I'm not trying to gas myself up. I'm just saying, I'm saying people legit don't remember. Like, even Nate Shot was on stream the other day and he's, like, talking about me a little bit. And he was like, when did Zuma come in? Like, I think he came in through Ghost, but he didn't really win an event till, like, AW. And I was like, no, I won an event in Ghost with my man Jay. Like, that's where I came out. I won my first event on a pro team.
Bit.
Yeah, we beat it. I mean, I'm just saying, like, I feel like a lot of people just weren't around. I feel, and that goes to show how many new fans we have. Like, there's just people who weren't around.
I got people who think I was ass at, the community.
Yeah,
like,
they just don't
know because they weren't around.
They don't remember. And you were another one who was fucking disgusting. You know what I'm saying?
It was disgusting.
Yeah, he was nasty.
And Ghost Ant was nasty as fuck.
Yeah, that was my guy, bro.
I just ignore it.
Yeah, Jay was the sniping king. Bro, nobody could fuck with Jay Snipe. It was just like so many shit that people forget about, you know, because it was so, which is, hey, some people just weren't around, you know, that's what it is.
All right, next cue.
If you were magically healthy and you wanted to come back, which team do you see yourself joining next year? I mean, probably
New York.
probably New York. Do you see any teams besides the bottom four making drastic changes going to next season? If so, which teams?
Let me ask you a question on that, T.
What's up?
If you join New York, like, would you let me run your main AR?
Of course.
Oh, okay. All right, just checking.
Of course, you can't done.
Right.
But not the sub, because Asim's my
sub.
No.
That's why I asked.
Yeah. Of course.
Okay, all right, just check.
But I agree with this. I think everybody would change, not just the bottom four. I think a lot of teams are changing, brother. A lot. I could see, like, every team except for maybe the top two, top three changing. Every other team changing.
Absolutely.
Including Optic. I could see Optic changing if things don't go their way for the end of the year.
What's
going to
happen with Thieves? This is what's wild.
They're going to fuck it. I have no idea.
They made so many moves, bro.
If the league expands to 16 teams next season,
you know what's
going to
happen with the
Thieves,
bro.
Season?
Come on, man.
Ideal format. What do you mean? What's happening
with
the Thieves?
Wait, what's funny? Come on, just use your head and just think about it. You'll be able to, you know?
I see it now.
I mean, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
All right.
Let it out, Don. What are they gonna do?
I don't know nothing.
Okay. I have a prediction for the Thieves roster.
Yeah. Let's hear Z's prediction for the Thieves roster.
Oh shit, Hulk, because he knows how to play.
It's gonna be Octane, Hulk, Draza, and Venom.
No, really? What about Kenny Z? What the
and
fuck?
Kenny, fuck, not Venom, Kenny.
It's good. I don't know. Kenny, they're building around Kenny and Draza. They're gonna keep Kenny. They're gonna keep Draza, and then maybe bringing I don't know, maybe Octane. Hulk, who the fuck knows? But Kenny and Draza, they'll probably keep.
Kenny, Draza, Hulk. Octane, boom.
Unless somebody here knows something,
he might be
else.
Onto something, bro. That might be close. It might be.
unless somebody here knows something else, I don't know. It wants to speak up.
No.
Okay,
sure.
On to the next one. If the league expands,
talk about butter though. That's a good one.
Butter? Where's that? If the league expands to 16 teams next season, what is your ideal format for the season? What do you mean format? What does he mean by this, guys?
Like what do we do? Like do we do majors and stuff like that? I think Black Ops 4 season. Fire.
That was elite, bro.
Let's do that. Let's just do that.
This is what you're talking about, butter. I didn't see this shit.
BO4 was the best, bro.
I saw Clint say that, and I 100% agree. Black Ops 4 season was fire. That's what we should do for
matches. Mattered a little bit, but not like OD.
Yeah.
And there was tournaments, and like, bro, if you got top four at the first major, like you just chilled for like 3 months. Like, that was elite.
That's what we need to do. We need to do Black Ops 4 season. It's epic the entire time. It would be lit, bro. I had a blast. That entire fucking season was great. It was lit every major event.
Is butter the best thing to add to any food?
It's up there.
I love butter.
It's top three.
Parmesan, bro.
Butter and pasta, butter and bagels, butter and fucking lobster, butter and fucking everything.
You can put butter on any type of meat.
Parmesan is fire too, bro.
Yeah, cheese is good too.
Cheese is up there.
Cheese is definitely up there. How many people not starting on teams now get to onto a starting roster next year? Not many.
There's
a couple, though. There's a couple that most likely will make their way back.
Let's try and find one more. I'm trying to find a good one. This is an optic one. People will probably eat this shit up. If the OG Dynasty were all in their prime today, then do you think they would replicate the same amount of success back then, or at least win 2 or 3 tournaments a year at the most?
Wait.
When they were all in their prime, you talking about Karma, Krim, and Scum?
Wait, he's saying if the OG Dynasty...
I think he's saying like, if they was in their prime now? Today, if they were in their prime playing today, would they be able to? They'd still be fucking
be
gross.
Yeah, they'd be fucking disgusting.
They'd be fucking nasty.
In their prime,
no doubt.
Yeah, I think for sure they would be fucking doing their thing, 100%.
Well, because like Damon was like not even in his prime when they were winning those tournaments.
Yeah.
So like, if Damon was in his prime, it's over. Yeah.
This is a good question. Listen, man, we'll end it right here. Can you talk about your opinions on how to rebuild a team such as LAG, who have no one I would
squad wipe,
or London, who have a few people doing very well and some people struggling? Agreed, Ant. I would squad wipe. I would find the superstar player that I really want. I'd give him a bag and build around him.
Yep.
I'd build around him.
Did that and they fucked up.
Who?
LAG just did that. They got Vivid. Vivid was the guy they were building around.
Yeah, but they're morons. They got rid of their...
But they built around with old veterans. You got to go get people teased talking about.
That's what I'm saying. But like, they basically just have to do the same thing they just did.
Yeah, but listen to what I just said, though. You
got to get a superstar.
No, but listen to what I said, though. No, listen, because Vivid is a really good player.
Yeah, go ahead, T.
You get your superstar player and listen to him on what he wants to do, and they did the opposite. They didn't listen to him.
And they dropped his ass.
They dropped his fucking ass. They put him on the bench. And now he's on a top three team.
Or honestly, if I'm LAG and I'm the owner of it, I would hire a new GM to be keep it a buck. Because that guy has not made good decisions in the last couple of times they've had big roster changes.
Who's the GM?
I have no idea who it is. And I'm not trying to fucking come at him that hard, but it's just true. Like, they have not made good decisions. They need to be... Like, dropping Chino and Vivid to me right there is just like, what are you doing?
Mm. Yeah.
I agree. It sometimes, like, some roster changes that some of these teams make, they really do make no sense. Like, I don't understand where they're coming from. Like, I don't get it. And that's why I get so frustrated half the time on a show. You know, when I'm fucking, you know, I get really, really passionate about some of my opinions. It's because, like, when opinions happen, bro, Ben will text me, you see this? And me and Ben say the same thing, that they're going to suck every time. And we've been spot on with pretty much every team. I mean, going into the year, like, if we said a team's not going to do well, we were pretty much right for the most part. There's definitely some toss-ups where, like, I don't know, it could work, we'll see. But there's definitely a lot of teams that were made in it. Like, the LAG team, we didn't think it was going to work from day one. We didn't think it was going to work. Just because, not because they're bad players, but because you compare them to the other teams on the...
Yeah, it's just not going to work, bro. It's like, go get some AMs who are hungry and at least work that out, like...
It's also, like, other things, too, like play styles and a whole bunch of shit, but... Would you guys agree? Any other way you guys would go about things? Like, Don, I see you pondering over there. Is there something?
No,
you
I was actually just reading Twitter. Nah, I mean, they just need to get a sub player and build around them. Nothing else they can do. That's what they just did.
I feel like
a sub player. You would do a sub player? Does it matter?
Yeah, I feel like at 4v4, you need the subs, man. Like, if you got two good, I'm not gonna say the AR. You can slot like ARs, and there's obviously better ARs than other ones. But like, if you have a nasty sub, this guy's just running around going in first, like. I'm a go positive, bro.
100%.
You know what I'm saying?
No. The sub player is important, man.
You need a sub. Get a sub, and then the ARs, you can get. I would just get the AR players last.
Yeah.
if I was building the team. Like, you need a sub, man. You need a good sub.
Wait, look at what Zinni just tweeted. You guys see that?
What did he tweet?
Look at this shit. He tweeted out a screenshot. Money Cheen added you to their.
Yeah, Cheen just added me to that,
bro. He did that too. That's what I was looking at.
He's a weirdo for that.
He added you to the can't guard me list. He did that to all you guys?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Cheen's fucking comedy, bro.
Can guard Cheen. I've guarded him multiple times.
Oh, shit. That's actually fucking comedy, though. That's fucking comedy. But listen, man, I think we had an amazing show today, man. I think it was a good show.
It was fun.
Listen, it was great. I want to give a huge thanks to you, Don. Thank you to Donnie, man, for hopping on. Listen, 20 minutes notice. This guy was already in the call, camera on, ready to go. So I just want to show Temp some love, guys. So make sure you guys go follow him at Donnie Temp on Instagram, at Temp on Twitter. Make sure to go show him some love because he deserves all of it. So thank you for joining us today, Don.
Appreciate you for having me.
Yeah, it was great, man. What the fuck is that?
And then, I'm chewing on a straw.
No, you're good. You're fucking good. I do that too.
I was zoning out on Twitter, bro.
I do that too, honestly. And then I also, Nameless is another one who I was going crazy because nobody was answering me, and Nameless ended up answering me as well, said he would hop right on. So I want to give a big thanks to Nameless and, of course, Study for coming on the show. I appreciate you.
No problem,
you guys,
brother.
Honestly, I liked the crew we had today. I thought it was fun. I thought it was a lot of fun.
Good vibes.
It was a good time.
Good convo. So thank you guys for coming on. Let's get a Wameless. Let's get a Waddy. Show these guys some love. And then Z and Soap, they're always in here chilling. They don't say much, but they come in with some ad libs sometimes.
Soap was a great addition, bro.
Soap. He said
one thing the whole show. He said LAD's fucking suck.
All my homies hate Soap.
He said LAD's is shit. Yeah. I know a lot of people don't like Soap because he likes to talk a lot of shit, but he always keeps it strictly COD for the most part. I don't know, Soap. I don't know what the fuck you do. So if you got beef with people,
listen, I just keep it real, man. Some people don't like being told they suck.
Yeah, I guess so, Soap. But whoa. Thank you for joining us. Z, why you gotta add the whoa? Why you know what I'm saying? But guys, listen, man, as always, make sure to go subscribe on YouTube. All right, hit that sub button if you haven't already. Go to anchor.fm/theflank. Well, you guys could check out. We're on Spotify, Apple, all that good stuff. We have it all listed up on there. Make sure to go follow The Flank on Twitter, at The Flank. Gersh is doing a great job over there running socials. So
traitor.
Yeah, he's a traitor, I guess. But he's been doing a great job. So he still does stuff for you too, no, man?
No, he's a great guy. We went dormant. He's killing it, bro.
He does a lot of work for not just me, but Gersh does a lot of work for a lot of people, man. So go show some love to Gersh. Go follow The Flank Twitter. And as always, guys, we appreciate you watching. We'll be live tomorrow after the matches. I'm gonna keep streaming, probably play some games and just have a good time on stream. But I know things were a little bit different today. Ben ended up bailing, so it is what it is, but we had Don come in, so I just want to thank all these guys real quick. And listen, guys, throughout the weekend, it might be a little sketchy, all right? I'm going to be controlling, like, the games and shit. It's a little fugazi, but I'm doing the best I can to try and control everything and control all the scenes and get everything that I need to get on the screen while also talking and having a good show. So I appreciate everybody coming on to help me out. I appreciate all the positivity and energy in the chat, and as always, guys, have a good day. All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow for another episode of The Flank.